Hopefully we've got this thing going on live now.
Is that the newest one? Is that a 606?
Yeah.
Yeah. We're gonna watch all of that. I just wanted you to make sure you saw the Muhammad Ali fight.
This is awesome, dude. It's like watching fucking the 6 o'clock news.
It's kind of what I thought.
That guy's gonna be the quarterback.
Do you think over this new guy?
I think it's gonna be Graham Mews.
Kevin Mews? Mews?
I think it's gonna be the dude from
Fresno. Fresno. Babcock is here. He's just trying to find a place to park.
No problem. Fucking sucks. I got here a little bit late thinking it's going to be empty because there's like nothing. I didn't know the school right now. Is there a class?
There's graduations. All kinds of little graduations.
Well, yeah, I know, but that's usually just on that side of the mountain.
Well, they have pinnings and different little types of ceremonies at the Fox Plaza, the Fox Fine Arts.
The Fox Plaza.
The Fox Plaza. Hey!
Hey, there he is.
Terrible about you. I see you, Chris.
I see you guys.
I know you met Mike and Michael.
Well,
Chris and Michael, man. You know we
from
those.
Yeah, hell yeah.
I'm digging that hat, man.
That's sweet, bro.
Yeah.
Is that the what could have been?
Yep.
No.
That's the Padres.
The Padres.
They had like a Padres name,
right? Oh, wow. That is awesome.
I think the Padres should go back to that uniform.
I have that argument all the time. It's like, oh, it's one of the worst uniforms. I said, Padres and Astros from the 70s? Those are the shit.
Hey, I like that Astro one.
Mm-hmm.
Damn, well, yeah, everybody having graduations.
Dude, bargain out there was atrocious.
It's in that way all day, man.
I mean, like that for like the next week and a half.
I thought EPISD was done.
No, they haven't even started yet.
I know. When I posted the story,
Sletta, Hanks, everybody, man.
I thought that we were the last ones to Horizon because it was us in Mountain View.
Oh yeah.
On yesterday, I was like, man, it's been a hell of a. And then they sent me the release date. Sunday graduations, 3 o'clock. What?
Yeah. I have a Franklin graduates on Friday night. My nephew's in that class, and then Saturday morning I'll be back. Jefferson graduates at 10, so I got to go back to that graduation.
Damn.
Which is cool. I mean, I love the kids.
My problem is these guys don't know how to work roundabouts. So they put into those things and they stop first, then they wait, and then they go, mm-hmm. Oh, Shane, it's cool to be safe. Get the hell out of the goddamn way, man. The yield means to slow down, not to stop. I mean,
yeah, that's why it's a roundabout.
Exactly.
You're supposed to continue your momentum through the turn.
I've seen Thank people like, stop right in the middle of the roundabout.
Yeah, that dude.
That's the worst. I'm trying to find out.
Are horrible. We just need to get rid of people in general.
Telling you, man.
I concur.
It's the easiest way. Easiest test in the world.
What?
Give them a shopping cart. Give them 10 items. Test number one is a 5 items or less aisle. If they go that way, you're halfway to getting rid of them. You say, okay, you know what? You're all right. That's right. But you're going to have to go ahead and scan it. And if they can't scan those five items, just go right to that door.
Yeah.
And it's an 80-foot drop.
Mm. Bye, Felicia.
Do you want a champagne of beers? You know how I like?
That's fine. Oh, you said the right word.
Good stuff.
The champagne, champagne of beers. That's my choice, man. That's my jam.
Dude, I like that. It's nice and affordable. Not cheap. Affordable.
Are we live?
It's live right now, but I haven't found this freaking thing to stream.
Totally.
I haven't found it on my phone. So if you guys can go to YouTube and try to search this out.
Yeah, that's exactly the one. I've gone from this one to the Cooler Shorties, you know,
little banquets. Yeah.
I'm good, man.
Tiffin?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm Tiffin. Been doing all
night. Hey, Mike, this is your USB drive in here, right?
Venus?
Yes. I don't ever think I've ever had
it. I can't hear you, man. Hold on.
Really?
It's a
champagne
drive, right? I don't want to.
Your USB drive is already in here?
Always sir.
Okay.
I'm not big on Coors Light. That's my
I actually like Coors Light.
This one?
I'm a Bud guy.
So I've also been doing me a
high school,
favor.
Yeah, first beer.
You
and I like a 40 that we passed around
as well.
A 68 Chevelle.
Where am I looking at? Right, what's your
channel? Is it 69? Mike Tipton or Mister or the Shootout Podcast?
Okay.
On YouTube?
Yeah. I think it'll be easier for me to find it on my damn people.
Come over here so I don't look so fat on camera.
Yeah. Show my good side.
I don't have one.
All my sides are good. Yeah, so everybody knows, Mr. Babcock was Jenny's teacher in high school.
Oh, wow. Well,
we went
fun
to
with
football
that.
Game, we went to a football game. She thought, he's my teacher. I'm all, who, Babcock?
Yep. Oh, in one of my previous lives, I was a teacher for 7 years.
Oh, cool.
And you know what I said? I was like, but he's so young, to your credit. I was like, he's pretty young to be your teacher. She's all, well, he was really young and he was our teacher.
He's like, don't lie to me. Jenny.
Not finding it too.
It still has the. I need to fix the name on it. Shootout is two words. Like a genius.
Yeah, we're live. I found it.
Awesome.
Where'd you find it, Vossel?
Under the Shootout Podcast, where we did the live stream for the draft pick too.
That's Vossel, by the way. He's our intern.
He's our
Vossel, say hi to Babcock.
He's our baby boy.
He's our fuck boy, so he said.
I said he's our baby boy.
Oh,
I hear fuck boy.
I said that the wrong way. Sorry. Great audio.
The one time we actually capture audio. Let's see what I can do to shoot.
You guys have a hashtag or a Twitter? I can grab.
Yeah, on Twitter it's at Shootout Podcast.
And a Facebook.
And a Facebook page.
And in face? Porno en el face. Todo está en el face.
Un facial.
Should I start working on a Tinder page too?
Yes!
Wow.
Oh, John, can we get swiped right?
Shootout.
Yeah. Shout out.
You give a shout out to Shootout.
Yeah, we'll take it.
It gets confusing. Before we get all serious, we're just hanging out, doing all these things.
I was very, very surprised to see. I sent out the release for the championship game.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody picked up on it.
Really?
Everybody. It's been my most shared story so far.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
And then apparently, I don't know if you saw Harold's post. He's posted on the RGFL board. He took a picture of one of his players getting interviewed. They had three cameras there. All three stations in Midland. So it's fun.
Midland will bring a lot of people.
I'm trying to push your KVIA, but they're a little slow to want to get into that party. You know, Kevin.
I don't care, but I bypass Kevin. So I know, having worked there, I bypass Kevin.
Right.
I send it to Brenda, and then I give it to the two sports anchors, and then they do their own thing on the weekend. At 7 o'clock, I know for a fact there's nothing else going on.
Especially now. There's nothing real local. There's nothing big. There's nothing going on.
Copa America.
Yeah. Well, that, but that's not our local.
That's not local.
So. Yeah.
And Kevin really didn't like
Copa
it.
America, nobody cares.
Kevin loves local shit.
I love.
Anything local we get, he loves.
Oh, yeah.
So,
I love. Copa América.
Of course.
We were watching the Mexican broadcast.
Yeah.
And my son was like, my son's like, why are you watching? I said, listen.
Yeah.
More exciting.
More exciting because these guys call it, they call it the British style. It's like, oh my God, you guys. Just have fun with the freaking game.
Back of the old onion bag.
Ding, 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 ding.
Cool, so that's cool. So I tag you guys in the thing on Facebook.
Sweet.
Why not you put a Metro friend on Facebook?
Oh.
Absolute garbage juice right now. Right?
He ain't even your friend in real life.
Everybody else. I mean,
this is the first time I've met him.
Freaking the mayor over here, you know?
I was freaking the mayor one time. And let me tell you.
He was such a good boy.
He was. His mama said it too.
Generally, I like the idea of being mayor, but the one that was coined for me over at 7 was the Viceroy of Favens. That had a certain ring to it that just added that much more class to the title.
Hashtag truth.
That is some truth right there for you. Mm-hmm. I'll post this on the Reaper's page and all that. We have like 2 viewers. Right now,
already?
That
nice.
That was me and Michael Monson. Yeah. Boss all tuned out. Like he said, no, I'm not watching this.
Jerk move.
Yeah, right.
I saw the radio body. I'm kind
of
turned off.
Turn it on, Bossel.
What are you drinking over there?
That's all boy.
The chilada.
You have clamato? You had these? The extra lime?
I don't like clamato.
I had shots for that.
I don't like them either. I hate tomato juice, but I fucking love me these extra lime tomatoes? Try them, Montez.
No, I don't like those. I tried those.
I don't want it.
Your pressure's a motherfucker.
Throw your mind, Montez.
I'm okay with it. No, I'm good.
It's just not regular lime. It's better than extra lime.
Extra lime. No, I'm good. Thanks, though, buddy.
He'll chloroform
you. You can drink it this way, or you can take an A and be wrong.
No, thank you, but no, I'm good. Appreciate it.
All right, well, fuck y'all.
I can't get it to tag the...
The tag the what?
The Reapers.
I noticed that today. There was I was having to go back 2 or 3 times to tag people.
A very professional sound.
Conspirical.
Conspirical. Yes, it is. We're just waiting for Michael Montez so he can start.
Oh, my bad.
No.
Hey, sound check, my bad. Sound check.
Me? Yeah, you.
Oh, okay. I thought, I was already talking. That'd be more than enough time for you to kind of check out whether or not I was potted up correctly.
I was lost in thought of hearing your beautiful voice, and I couldn't.
You know what? You just found your way to my heart.
Oh.
All righty. Chris, can you?
1, 2, 3. 3, 2, 1.
Okay,
Will. It's only been
16
wow,
shows.
I know, 16 of them.
So 16. Hammered,
the guy I hate with Bossel.
Is, like, is that Will then?
He's the worst.
Michael Montez.
Titties and beer. Titties and beer.
God,
I thank God Almighty for titties and beer.
Titties and beer.
Thank God I ain't born. All right. We don't need a countdown, boss. So we'll just start off.
Yeah, we don't need you.
Yeah.
And your numbers.
And your math. Your science.
The 12.0.
Yeah. Blood alcohol.
BAC. He's our bat boy.
Yeah, he is. You ready, Mr. Montez?
Absolutely, man.
Is there Mr. Facebook?
Yeah, Facebook and all.
I'm trying to tag the link and it's not working.
Doesn't look like it. Mm-mm. Looks like looking at cars.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Look like Pornhub over there. Yeah. Not that I would know.
Did anyone have that yet?
What is Pornhub?
What is Pornhub? I'm a good Christian boy.
Dictionary.
It's connected to the half shaft. It's like a car part. It's the Pornhub. It's right off of the differential.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I like that. The half shaft.
It's next to the red tube.
I have a half shaft.
yeah, semi half.
It's just a half shaft.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you can hear, we're having a good time right now on the Shootout Podcast. I'm the gunslinger, Michael Tipton, alongside the gifted growler, Will Herring.
Panda. Panda. Panda, 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 panda. I got bras in Atlanta. I got Dolce & Gabbana. I got my scammers on. No panda?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Do you get a panda?
No. And panda. We'll move on to another subject. We have Michael Montes, the 16. Voice of the Tigers, here with us. And it is our honor to bring along Chris Babcock, who apparently has bras in Atlanta. But he's here to talk to us about a little something that's going on this weekend, guys. Something that we've been to. We've seen a couple of these games. Chris, let us know what's going on.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I appreciate it. It is the Rio Grande Football League's Grande Bowl 2. It is the championship game. It's coming up. And there you go.
Stop making noise.
I've never had walking music. That's pretty good. That's
walk-up music. That's your intro.
That's nice. I like that. Although I did have Johnny Cash play for me once at the Diablos game when I had a softball game.
Really? Yeah,
that is cool. Awesome.
What song was it?
Walk the Line.
Yeah.
Yeah, it came up and I hit a triple.
What he's being modest about is actually Johnny Cash in person.
He's going to throw the ball.
He came specifically.
He was pitching
specifically for Chris Babcock. But going back to the RGFL championship game, the Grande Bowl, tell us a little more about.
Hold on, real quick, before we get started on this. I'm just saying. Nice first time Chris has been there. First off, you know we're live on the YouTubes, right?
Yeah.
You don't have any warrants or anything, do you?
Oh, not in this part of the
country. I was going to say, Sheriff's Department's not going to show up out of the way like that, knock on the door.
No, there was this one thing where we had to get some beer to some politicians over in Atlanta. And that's yeah, we got that
okay.
Covered.
Cool, just checking. I know Chris from like 2010. Do you remember that?
Yep.
Do you remember the KVIA, KLAQ softball game?
The Melee?
The Melee Madness?
Yes. I remember that was a pretty good game, though. I mean, it was all those games. I guess we're the reason they don't have them anymore. But we were having those. It was for who was it? It was the
one of Brad's charities, yeah, right? Million Coins for Kids.
El Paso's Fighting Hunger. There really you go. Good. So we'd hype it up for the next month or so, get people out there.
And charity game
for
kids.
Come in and bring at least a can, and you can come in and you can yell at Bob Harp or. Where was out there, Lou Romano, and boo him as much as you wanted to.
Yeah.
And we ended up playing you guys in the first round, and it was the way it was set up that year. I think we lost two teams because there were supposed to be six teams. No, there were supposed to be eight teams. There were only five, so somebody had to sit out the first round, and it was not going to be who beat you. It was point total. I think is what it was.
I wasn't in any of the tournament. I was just the instigator.
He was a bat boy.
After they started fighting.
He was drinking in the parking lot till it was time to fight.
Yeah, I was like, ooh, did you hear what he said? Ooh, did you hear what he said? Ooh, I wouldn't take that. Ooh, I'm going after.
That was
me.
That was the thing. The thing that got everybody going the most was the fact that we showed up in uniform. I mean, it flipped people out.
Kevin bought uniforms?
No, I bought
uniforms. I was going to say, it's too cheap for that.
That sounds something like, yeah. That's not like Kevin. Babcock would do.
Yeah. It's like 2010. That was the year that we went, I think we went red. Yeah, we had the Diablos uniform. We went red and gray.
Nice.
And everybody came out really nice, and everybody on the Q's team was just wearing whatever, polo shirts and pantaloons and
pantaloons.
And I do remember that we got that it started out during warm up because Romano was there and he was with the team, and he comes out of the dugout and he's wearing these pinstripe baseball pants and the New York Yankees pullover warm up.
I was gonna say go Yankees.
He came out and he had the Yankees jersey on and everything, and everybody just started getting on it. And it all went downhill from there. It ended up with a hard slide, and then a hard slide in the second, and then somebody got mad. And then after the game, where you're supposed to be shaking hands, Donnybrook time. Everybody really? Just started throwing down. It was crazy. The crowd loved it.
We need to get this started back again because I'm at the queue. You're at KVIA. It needs to go down.
I'm all about it. You know what I mean?
I've got a team with the Herald Post. We're down to play.
Ooh, there we go.
Three-way championship. I like it. Locked. Yeah, so they were throwing down, and of course, me, I'm like, ooh, there's an opportunity here. Yeah, and there's chaos, and it creates a ladder, right?
I'll announce the game. I'll just sit up in the box, watch everybody, take camera, take video of the fight.
So they got all mad at
each
other.
I'm going to get a hold of a bloop single and do a backflip.
Bautista?
Bautista style.
How old are you? I owned this gym on Donovan and Sunset back in the day. And it was a good time, but basically we were just working so everybody could play. We just made enough to pay the bill and no profit. So I was like, well, why don't we talk to KVIA and KLAQ and be like, hey, why don't we do a dodgeball tournament for charity, which is one of KLAQ's charities, and we'll have it at my gym. So everybody showed up.
Oh,
Chris yeah. came, Buzz came, all KLAQ. Steve Kaplowitz was there. He was being such a jerk. I was
You're a little, dead ass right he was there.
I was a little nervous because I have all these like, important people in our gym, and I'm trying to like MC and stuff like that. I can't MC it the way Steve wanted it done. So he took the microphone. He did it himself. It's a dick. So he did his thing, and then
they, dead ass right. He took that microphone.
The KVI came like you had a dodgeball to throw out. It was awesome. Chris was good. Buzz, he had a ball in his hands, and like someone threw the ball and knocked it out of his hands. So he's out. Right? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Those
fit.
Are the rules.
He had a fit. Is that ever seen this? Oh, man. Man, it was like a little kid out there upset and everything. So, ask him about it. He'll remember.
That's classic. So, like,
and then we just soccer and anybody that's up, man, let's throw down with some.
There's a KVIA. Like, Trevor's a really good
basketball.
Basketball.
Okay, sorry.
Who I can name out. I got no
idea. Everybody I know.
Buzz, and Steve, that's yeah. three.
Oh, yeah. We're at three. Wow.
Over under five tonight.
It's hell being popular.
It's hell being popular.
Well, you know, I was talking to Fonzie Gomez.
Hey! We love Fonzie.
Yeah. Who we already all know?
I was talking with Dennis Wu earlier today. So
he's big time. That's a big name.
Well, we were also talking to Mossel, but that's...
No, he's Mossel.
That doesn't count. Yeah.
That's half.
I'd say a quarter. But we got sidetracked there a little bit. Thank you, Will Heron.
You're welcome. We have
Let's
a little
get
backstory.
Back to the real brand name.
Yeah,
that was a great story.
But the RGFL championship game is coming up. Who's playing against who? Where is it?
Whatever. I don't care about this game. We're going to talk about it.
You're going to go. We'll let you for free.
Thanks.
You can do the coin toss.
Sun Devils.
Hey, last year they had Austin Trout do the coin toss for this.
Ooh. Vossel, you should fight him.
At halftime.
Austin Trout. Damn.
Look at this.
Wow.
Okay, Will, all
right,
we're going to talk RGFL championship game.
My ADD is flying.
One more outburst and your mic is going off.
Every time it's happening.
So, Chris, who's in the game?
It is the Western Division champs who knocked off Las Cruces Kings. It's the Sun City Reapers.
Yeah.
9-2. Did what no other team could do, which was knock them off. They hadn't lost since last March. We got close. We were able to put a... Almost got it, but they got it done.
Who's we? Because you're saying we,
sorry.
People don't know your affiliation.
I'm sorry. The El Paso Armor. I'm the general manager and defensive tackle. So there you go.
Man.
Which is fun. But
do you really still play?
I didn't play this year.
Okay.
I had a little contractual obligation, which is a fancy way of saying I have no health insurance.
And
the wife would not let me play. So
pretty smart of her.
Once I'm signed up again, I'm going to go out there.
Really?
I'm going to give my full four quarters of support for the team. No, right. not in the same game.
Not in the same game.
I mean, it might be the first quarter in the first game and then two or three somewhere. It's not going to be sequential.
Emotional support.
Because there's some real big dudes in this league.
There's some big dudes. And the biggest dude that put me down was with the Las Cruces Kings three years ago.
Ashton Butler.
I think that's who it was.
Number 69.
69, yeah.
He likes
to talk a lot.
Oh, he's funny.
He's funny.
But you know what?
Burger King.
I will give the Kings this. After they lost, they took it like men. Like, they were really, really upfront about it, and they said, hey, you guys beat us. Good luck in the championship. Beat the pride.
It was a couple of good organizations.
It was classy. They handled it real classy.
And that is the other side of it. It's the 10-1 West Texas Pride out of Middle Odessa, and they're coming in as Eastern Division champs, and they pretty much just run roughshod over everybody in that division. And it's going to be probably the best matchup we've had team for team where it won't be like this huge blowout. And I say the history of the league because RGFL is only 2 years old. But really, the what's called the New Mexico Premier Football League. So it was like very, wow, marbles. And they were around for a long time. And what we have now, I think, is a lot more legit, for lack of a better word, legit. Because we have franchise stability, we have divisions, we have rules, we have bylaws. We have everything that we're following now. And I think that this year, this is the turning point for this league, because we do have a fairly drama-free season. I mean, you know, a couple
there
of
were some things here and there.
Bumps.
There was some.
Game called at halftime.
Did you go to the game on Saturday?
I did not.
It was, if the RGFL could do that every Saturday, this league would be so big. Because, I mean, both teams played clean. There was no issues in the stands. There were no issues on the field. It was just a great, great game. And the atmosphere was awesome. I mean, it was at the Field of Dreams in Cruces, so the setting was awesome. It was, if the RGFL could just find a way to pull that off every Saturday, I mean, this league could really grow. But until they get rid of all the little bumps and, you know, the bumps we're talking about.
Growing pains.
Yeah, the growing pains and stuff. If they can get past that and stay on course, it can grow. I mean, because it was amazing on Saturday night. I really do believe it'll be like that this Saturday, because it's a real brand new bowl. Everybody will be on their best behavior. It's in Horizon. Yeah. Why are we playing it in Horizon, Chris?
The league, we talked about it. We were looking for a really good, not necessarily a neutral site, because really we're still here in the backyard for the Reapers. But we wanted a facility that everybody could use, everybody had played on, and most of the teams had played on it. And they agreed, best field so far, great locker rooms, great access. So league awarded it to the Armor, and we're just going to put on, you know, one of the best shows that we can put on. But Clint ISD has been very, very good with us this year. It's been a battle. And I mean, of course, you guys know with the Sun Devils and the Reapers, how hard it is to get a field and get a field consistently. Mm-hmm. And our problem was 2 years ago, we lost our home field because they were supposed to be doing improvements to the SAC, the Socorro Stadium. Well, they didn't do it. But we didn't sign up on time because they said we're going to be closed. So we only got one home game 2 years ago. So we were nomads. We played one game there. We played two games at Austin. We pretty much shot our wad on the Sun Bowl twice. I mean, I just blew my budget from now to the end of this decade. Mm-hmm. But it looked cool. I'll give you that much. But for this league to succeed, we need partners in these school districts with good stadiums, like Las Cruces Public Schools, like Alamogordo, like
Canyatillo.
You know, in Midland, Chronic Communications Stadium, my goodness. I mean, everybody likes to play Ratliff, but if you've been to the stadium, it's awesome.
A beautiful stadium.
And they were able to get it. And they were able, once you secure the field, that's 50% of your battle, because then you just start doing the promotion and everything else. But choosing Horizon High, aside from, you know, its location, it's beautiful. I mean, it's the high desert. Once the sun goes down, it gets real nice and comfortable. You know, we push the game time start from 6:05 to 7:05, just in case. We've got the lights all the way to 11 o'clock, so we should be okay this time. We won't have a repeat of the first game where 9:30 lights clicked off, which is the first game this year. But it was fun. It's fun. And it's one of those situations where I tell the guys, especially with a game like this, we've had less problems this season than we did last season. Yeah, there's been some hiccups, like I said. But those games, like you mentioned, with last week's game, with our game against the Sun Devils, nobody got ejected. Nobody, you know, there was not these huge drama issues outside. Nobody's mom got butt hurt because their kid got hurt real hard. And it was a good game. They were good, hard-hitting games. And I think as the league moves forward, these are the type of games we're going to have. And that's what this league needs, because they're just everybody and their brother thinks they can start a league. And that's not the way it works.
Right.
And not to talk smack about any of their leagues, but when you have, like, when 2 years ago when we came in, when we were the Raiders, we ended up making the championship game, and we played the New Mexico Titans, who are this huge, you know, fancy team out of Albuquerque.
Yeah.
Well, the game was set for Belen, and we show up, and game time is 2 o'clock on a Sunday afternoon. This time of year in Belen,
It's about 100 degrees.
Yeah, at least in the desert.
Yeah. So the school district only lent them the field. No locker rooms.
Oh wow.
No running water.
Oh wow.
Yeah. So it's okay. You know what? We're used to this. This is how we played. No big deal. And then we see the Titans show up, and we see some guys with different colored jerseys. Well, it turns out that the Titans kind of, I don't want to say enhanced their roster, but there were a lot of people in that from the New Mexico Thunder, the Albuquerque Stars, which is the indoor. They had about a 85-man roster for that game, and they still beat us by 2 points.
Oh, wow. Convenience.
But I learned that. That game taught me a lesson. It's like, if we ever get the chance to realign this league and get serious about what we're going to do, and we host a championship game, it has to be a championship game. It has to be equal for everybody. Everybody gets locker rooms or nobody gets locker rooms. Everybody gets water, nobody gets water. And if nobody gets water, then you're playing in a rec league.
Yeah.
Yeah. And since then, you know, everybody's kind of come on board with the same thing. So
that's awesome to see the growth of that. You know, like you're saying, from going from having basically a field rented out with no water and all that to having a championship game in a decent, or actually more than decent, facility. I've been there. That's a nice field. And you know, you've got everything that you guys need, and you know, they're gonna put on one hell of a show, because we watched the game that the Reapers played against the West Texas Pride a few months ago, and that was actually a really good game.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't remember if the Reapers won. I think the Reapers won.
The Reapers won.
They ended their only losses.
They it was close. I don't remember if they were going for the win. I think they were. And then we got them on a fourth down. We stopped them on fourth down.
Yeah.
But they didn't convert the first.
See, I remember that because you were out in the field. But what I was going to get at is you have two teams who, you know, they met each other. The Pride have something to play for, not only to win a championship, but to try to, you know, prove that it wasn't some cupcake schedule that they went up against, because that's something from the page that we remember seeing. You guys played a bunch of cupcakes. But I think it's going to be a great game. Will, what do you think about this? I know you're a little salty over there. What do you think about that?
I don't know. Reavers cheated. But
what was that final score? What was that final score?
58-20 when they played the Sun Devils in the first round of the playoffs.
They cheated real hard. Man, no, they did fantastic. That's awesome. Congratulations, Montez. If any team was going to win and beat the stupid Queens, I'm glad it was you guys.
You know what the best part was in Cruces last week?
You still have to wear a jersey.
Yeah, well, you went there, and I met Coach Frias, and he asked me about that. Where's your jersey, man? I'm like, hey, buddy, that wasn't me. That's on Will.
You know what? I think that's a good thing for the championship game.
I'm not wearing it for the championship game.
You have to pay up your cash. What do you think?
I was there that day. It's not my fault he didn't show up that day.
No, we had a bet the first time that this season that the Sun Devils played the Reavers. Whoever won would have to wear, because I announced for the Sun Devils.
Right.
And obviously, Montez is the announcer. So whoever would win, the other person would have to wear the opposing jersey. And I don't know, things were really kind of rough. There was a lot of, that's when it was earlier in the season. Things are getting real crazy. So I was like, we'll back down a little bit from this bet. We didn't want to get things crazy, but yeah. That's what happened.
I'm happy to wear it for the game next year. I'm not going to wear it to the championship.
I think
on
what
Sunday.
We need to do is we need to leave it up to the league. If there's anybody from the league that's listening to this podcast, you know, just go ahead, chime in on the Shootouts Facebook page.
Definitely.
Let us know if Michael Montez should be wearing, should pay up on his bet at the championship.
I'll be posting right now.
There we go.
I'm not going to wear it on Saturday. I can tell you that right now.
It's happening.
I'll do it. I'll be happy to do it next year, like I was this year when I went to your game.
What weren't
there.
What good is paying up a bet a year later?
Yeah.
Why am I going to wear for the championship?
Because you've got to show your manliness.
Well, I don't with him in this one, because he's got to represent his team in the show.
I'm wearing Reaper stuff.
Like, a bet's a bet.
Like, I'm going to
support
the Reapers.
When you guys meet again,
I'm totally down to do that.
But no. I think everybody needs to wear
and he's from the league, and he's chiming in.
Oh.
He's hosting the championship game.
That's one
so
vote.
We're going to go with this guy.
One vote. Will also represents a team.
Bam,
there you go. That's a one-on-one.
Cancel it out.
You don't have to talk. Vossel, we'll get Vossel in on this.
He's with me.
Vossel?
You better
use it.
Sure,
whatever.
You got to love this kid.
But you know, I think it's this kind of excitement, this kind of back and forth, and that was one of the things, you know, in all the league behind the door stuff that we usually talk about. And I've been a big proponent of natural rivalries. And the problem with the way the league used to be set up is you didn't have that. You had, you know, Curry County was playing somebody else and had to fill in the game with an East Texas team, and there was really no. And then when you have four teams from Albuquerque. And one in Cruces, that doesn't make any sense.
It waters down the league a little bit.
We're a larger city than Albuquerque. Even that, you know, at least if you have one or two teams representing that city, then you can make a legit claim saying, yeah, now you're playing real games. Well, the thing was, after that championship game, they ended up pulling out the Titans, and they went into what's basically the Albuquerque League, and it's six, well, now it's down to four Albuquerque teams that play each other.
Wow.
And that's all they do.
Mm-hmm.
And I think going forward, the way this league is going to succeed is to bring in other teams from across, you know, and it's basically going to be the Rio Grande. It that's the way I look at it.
How far up do you think we should go? Albuquerque's too far.
Denver.
I don't think Albuquerque, Boise.
Hey, Manning.
No, we're not going to do Boise. I mean, Boise shouldn't even have NCAA teams, in my opinion. They should just have horses.
Boise State's pretty good at football.
Well, no, Anchorage.
Boise Anchorage.
White horse.
White horse. There we go. I've made that drive.
Yeah. Why not? How far north should the league go, and how far west should it go? Do you think the east is good to stop at Midland?
Well, that's the thing. That's the question that we're going to have to go over in this offseason, because we said, I kind of shoehorned it through, and I talked about controlling the value of the league. Don't expand 1 year by six teams and then come back by, you know, you lose four. You know, go every year by two if you need to. And I think in this offseason, we need to look at it, adding two teams. And I think one in the east and one in the west is the way to do it.
Now, and who would it be in the east? And is this county not okay? Because let's clear it up for everybody listening. The Outlaws were a team that folded
right
towards the end of the year. So they because only have
four. Yeah, they're players.
They're for pretty players much
decided folded to be buttholes.
Right. And they just kind of threw in the towel. So do you guys let them back and then another team in the east, or do you just want like one team, not counting the Outlaws?
As far as I'm concerned, the Outlaws are now a property of the league. That franchise, that whatever was that franchise, we have that franchise back.
Okay.
So if somebody says, hey, I'd really like to run that team back in Amarillo, go right in. Here you go. You're good to go. So I still see them as a viable team, because again, you have to have those natural rivalries in the east, because
and they're a perfect rival for Midland.
Yeah, they're a perfect rival for Midland,
for West Texas,
for West Texas, for anybody along that Pecos River line. Mm-hmm. That's where we need to have those rivalries. So I consider them still in the league, and if somebody comes forward and says, I want to run the team, fine, here's how you're going to do it, and it's going to be, we're going to administer that team. But if I had to pick another team to put in, I would probably go in the east. I really like the idea of Big Spring or something a little bit closer to maybe Dallas-Fort Worth, not too far out, because they're only going to play in the east. If you get six teams in the east, they can play up against each other in maybe one long road trip. In the west, this is where I have a lot of pushback. I really like Albuquerque, and I like Santa Fe, but I don't see those happening. I don't see anything in Shiprock, because they've lost two teams in 1 year. The Vipers, and there was another one that crashed out. If I can't get Tucson, because Tucson's very, very interested in playing this. I mean,
6 hours away?
That's five.
Dude, well, on I-10 too.
We've kind of got that informal relationship where the first and second place teams play their first and second place teams. So if we can continue that, I think that'll develop it. I like Tucson, but if we were going to go to the next level, I would pick Juarez. I would really
put it outside the box.
That's a great idea.
Yeah.
Like
let's go idea south.
Every year we get requests from the University of Juarez, the Indios, to play us. And it just depends on what our schedule looks like and when we can schedule a field. So they owe us a home game. They want to play us, but they just couldn't do it this year. So if we could get their next team, that'd be perfect. I mean, the ease at which you can now get across the border, and that franchise, and I call it a franchise, because it's a university team. They've got kids that have played American football for all their lives in the Juarez, basically the schools over there. So they're playing. We played them pretty good game. They had a good quarterback 2 years ago. But having that team there, they just want to play football and they want to hit. So when we went over, we walked across the bridge. There was a UCLA colored bus waiting for us. That's their colors. They got white, baby blue, and yellow. Guy says, come on, get on the bus. Get on the bus. They drove us to the field. We pull in. Everybody's like, yeah. We get off the bus. We play the game. They cheer for us. We had fans from Juarez that we didn't even know about.
Nice.
Wow. They were cheering for us. Of course, they had more fans for the Indios.
Right.
And then afterwards, they drove us right back to the bridge. It was very fun.
There's all the ex-girlfriends of the players on the Indios team. Like, yeah, kill them.
But that would be, to me, that would be perfect, because like then, from a marketing standpoint, now we can say, now you're a bi-national football league. And you just build on it. And then my out year plan, because Juarez plays a lot of games with Chihuahua City. And 2 years ago, the team from Chihuahua City wanted to play in the New Mexico Premier League.
They're not that far away either. Yeah.
It's 290 miles.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if you get Juarez and Chihuahua City, that's two teams right along the Rio Grande, good rivalries, playing us here. That brings us up to seven. Throw another team over to the east, Pecos, Alpine.
I'd say Odessa. Because you've got a natural rivalry with Midland and Odessa.
What happens if Trump builds his wall and the players can't get in?
I think we've got a heavy enough rush we can knock down that wall.
Okay. Yeah.
If we don't, they do.
They have a great defense. Don't forget
that. Oh, that's right, yeah. Louis Ariano. He's a big guy.
Hey, the other thing was like deadlifting like 1,000 pounds.
Yeah, right.
Did you see that on Facebook?
Yeah.
Who doesn't do that?
Yeah.
he had like 845s on one side or something.
Just, the bar's bending when he's going up and down.
Every time I look at his Facebook post, I get tired. Yeah. I break the sweat. I said, what the hell are you doing?
I'm curious though, going back to the Juarez team, how did they compare in size to the guys on your team?
They matched up pretty good.
Did they?
In fact, their running, their quarterback and their running backs were very quick. I mean, once they sealed us on the defense, and I know this because they love chop blocks, by the way.
Surprise.
Wow.
Yeah.
I mean, once they sprung them, they were as quick as anybody else in the league. The defense needed some work. They couldn't figure out how to make the adjustments. But again, that was 2-3 years ago. By now, again, as you progress, you get better. I would say that they would, if they were in the league for the long haul, it would take them 2 or 3 years to get used to the style of play, the speed. But once they got there, I think they'd be a, they'd be an asset to the league. I think they would be. And knowing the way that Juarez embraces its sports teams, it would be they would be an immediate success.
Well, like Midland. I mean, Midland, like you were saying, there were three people. They travel really well. And I'm curious, because this is a championship, I'm curious to see how many people they bring over here on
Saturday.
They're
going to be bench pressing cows. and see,
to me, that was my goal. Once, because the Sky Force last year, which was the Permian Sky Force
team,
they were just about trying to get it ready, but there wasn't somebody driving it from the top that would say, okay, this is how we're going to do it, and control the players and control the action. And with Harold over there, Harold Fuller, he's from the get-go. I'm the owner. Here's what we're going to do. Here, we're going to buy this. You're going to be on TV. And every step of the road, he's done it. And again, Midland Odessa, if you talk football, just football in the United States, you say, hey, what do you think about high school football? Oh, Midland, Permian Basin. That place loves its football. And not to say that we don't hear, but they've only got three high schools. And once that team wins, that team gets the bragging rights. Now, they're drawing from those three high schools, and they're drawing from the oil fields, and that's a strong team. And that's what I was hoping for, a strong team right in the heart of football country that would let people say, oh, we're going to have to go beat the crap out of Midland. Here we go. And it's the same thing again, as you get juiced for those games.
Midland League.
Yep.
Odessa Permian.
They, remembering them. Remembering them from.
Anymore? Dallas Carter.
Maybe.
Dallas Carter.
Just sorry, I'll tell you why I'm not.
Thinking back, they probably have the best quarterback. They probably have the best quarterback in the league in Chris Ware. I think he had 28 records at Eastern Oregon.
Yeah.
I mean, the guy's ridiculously good. There are two defensive tackles, 99. I know it's Cedric Patterson. I'm not sure what the other guy's name is. I know his number is 96.
This guy's like Wayne Man when it comes down to like
they're roster numbers
and
the names.
And you're talking about the West Texas Pride.
Yeah, this is the West Texas Pride. But they're phenomenal in the middle. The one thing they don't really have is a lot of edge players that can kind of break it. Like, they don't have game breakers on the edge. I thought actually their best running back was this kid number 24, Dustin Hicks or Dusty Hicks. But they didn't give him the ball that much. Like, they went to him, and then they kind of went away to it, which was, I thought was kind of odd. But maybe they set it up. I don't know.
They would come over here and just run right through you guys.
I don't know. I mean, but they haven't really played anybody in a month and a half. So we'll see. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, they haven't had a good game in who knows how long. So we'll see. I mean, the Reapers' defense is always going to be good. They're always going to bring it. The offense is on track. But can they move the guys in the middle enough to get the running game going? That I think, is going to kind of determine the whole game on Saturday.
Kendren Shepherd.
Yeah, I was thinking, Shep play? Is he going to be there?
Yeah, no, he's back. He's back. I didn't want to say it, but that's what I was thinking. But even in Saturday in Cruces, I mean, you know, it was hard to run in the middle. And so I kind of see the same thing. And if we can get some room on the outside or kind of get them going and, you know, not going the right direction, I think we'll be okay. But
I don't want to disrespect any of the other running backs out there in this league, but Shep is probably the best running back.
Oh, he's good. Cool, man. He's good.
He's good. Him and Tyrell Jackson from the Sun Devils, I thought, were the two best running backs. But then TJ left. I don't know what happened to him. He had to go.
Army stuff.
But yeah, him and Kendren, I think, were the best. But yeah, overall, I think Kendren's stronger than him, but he's as fast as him, I think. So,
and that was the key. And that's the key, is that when you have a championship game, you want to have these either or conversations. And that's what spurs the excitement of the game. And that we finally got it in these two teams. I mean, last year, the Kings, you kind of figured they were just going to win. I mean, they were just a little bit better than everybody else last year, and everybody else was down. I know that we were down.
Well, we beat the crap out of them in the first game, though.
Right.
And the thing about the championship is we didn't have Jordan.
Yeah.
See, and you know, that hurt us big time.
Well, where did he come from?
What was that sound?
No, he was hurt, though. But I'm saying, I mean, they won. They won.
Where did Jordan come from?
What do you mean?
Whose team was he on first?
He was on your team.
Oh, that's right.
And he left.
So he upgraded.
No. No, he didn't.
He left for a reason.
Did you see the wheels turning?
Yeah, he's like, wait, why?
I walked into that.
Yeah, he did. Why would you say that, bro? I was like, why are you setting yourself up there, Will?
Not.
But, Chris, before we take a break here, because we got to take a little bit of a break.
We got to feed our boss, so we got to water him.
Yeah.
He gets all uppity.
He needs more miracle, bro. the championship game coming.
He's a Muslim.
I'm putting you on the spot. Who's winning?
Ooh, I like this.
Boom, boom.
You know, and this is coming from someone who's been involved in both a divisional championship game and a championship game. You know, we lost to the Titans by 2 points, and that was because we let them back in the game. We had them by 2 touchdowns, and the refs and everything just kind of conspired to put them in a position to win. And then we lost last year against you guys in probably the most fluke play I've ever seen in my 25
years.
That's not
a fluke play. That's a pick six. That's what that's called.
That is
actually a pick two. Was
that
a point
is,
after
that
try.
Is a Rick. That is driving 92 yards with 49 seconds left with a rookie quarterback who didn't like to stay in the pocket. And if we had had, again, second row, you know, if we had had a kicker, it would have been just straight down the middle. I think that that's going to be this type of game. It's going to be that one crazy play that just breaks it open. And I got to believe, and because I haven't seen that much of West Texas play, I think it's going to be the Reapers. I think the Reapers have the edge.
Yeah.
And having had Kedren on our team,
you're gonna change yourself.
You don't know how big of a piece of an offense he is until he leaves. Because you can have a quarterback, have him go out and have a second string step up. You can have a fullback go out and have another one come in. But when you have a running back like Kedren who can go out and score 3 touchdowns in a game easily, that, and I'm saying that's even with just a regular line. But when you've got a line that's firing off and doing the things you need to do, you can't stop it. And I don't think that Midland has that type of back. And then you guys' quarterback, I mean, absolutely killed Horizon for 2 years straight in high school.
He was at Del Valle, right?
Yeah. He was at Del Valle. We hated going up against him because you knew he was going to beat you. So you put that type of quarterback with Kedren and his type of running, you just basically daring the Pride defense to say, you've got to change your game plan just to deal with these two guys. And that's not even talking, I'm not even talking about the pass game. I'm talking about the way that they can interact and set up the run plays. It's going to be close. I mean, it's going to be 31-27. It's going to be just one play either way that's going to count it. And again, having played you guys twice this year, 3% the edge.
31-27 is what he said.
What do you think?
Rape.
Yeah. If he was going to win, I want Montez's team to win. So.
Rape.
Word for the Sun Devils.
We already know who he's going for. Also, who do you think is going to win this game, man?
You better say it, you little.
Well, every game I've been to for the RGFL has been a Reaper game. So I'm going to back Montez for this.
Ravens.
Just to be an asshole, I'm going to go with the
front. There we go.
Yep. So I have to be that point.
Again.
That guy.
One play. It could be
Chris Ware. It could be.
It could be a referee making a bad call. That's what sucks.
We'll talk about that in a little bit. But, you know, from the game I watched. Yeah. I was there. I watched the whole game. That's not some chump team.
No, okay. Not at all.
I agree with Chris over here. One play. And I think that, you know, they've had a little bit of time to kind of digest that loss because it was a tough loss for them. Mm-hmm. They really had a shot to win that game.
Yeah, they did.
But, I don't know. There's just something about it. I'm doing it to be an asshole. I think just for that.
They very well could. I don't want to sound
unanimous. I hate unanimous.
Yeah.
So.
But it's an El Paso team, and you know.
Will you get a ring?
I don't know. I'm from Socorro.
I better not get a ring.
I don't know. The owners love.
I know.
They didn't give me a shirt, so I should go for the
front. Yeah, we need to get t-shirts. Yeah. We've been talking about that
since the beginning of the season.
Hector, we need to get tipped in a ring, man.
A ring, too? I want a ring, Hector.
I mean, a shirt.
No, you heard it.
I said ring.
It's recorded. It's live. Ring. There it is, Hector. You got it.
You're picking the Pride, bro.
You can take that out of his paycheck.
Yeah.
But everybody, we're going to take a quick break here. We got Chris Babcock. I don't know if you got anywhere to be.
I'm here.
Awesome. Awesome.
We can keep you around for a little bit more things going on. We have to get to Growler Will Herring. Panda. We have Panda. Panda. You look like you want to say something. Go ahead.
I got brawls in Atlanta. I was
waiting for him to finish because you're going to introduce me.
Those of you in Atlanta.
You're going to introduce me instead.
Yeah, I got brawls in my scanners.
We have Vossels Avenal.
Oh, yeah.
And we also have some guy. There we go. It's been so long since I've seen him.
I know, right? Last week. Where was he last week?
As being the president of the El Paso Alumni Association.
Jail.
There it is, drop dropper.
Did you know he's the president of the Alumni Association of Paso High School?
Yeah, we had that conversation online because we had the same problem. Because I thought I had some pull, at least, you know, trying to get El Paso High. He didn't.
He's
a man.
Yeah.
And he couldn't get it. So I was like, you know what?
Well, I've actually never asked for it.
Lisa doesn't know.
I never asked for it. So,
and on that note, we'll be right back, everybody.
I honestly have never asked for it. Because I know they're going to say no. Yeah. The principal will say no to it.
What was it, Mike?
Depends on who you ask.
I forgot the name of the high school. I don't want to be a little offensive right now.
We're the drugs and the hookers.
Here's the deal. Every time we've gone after it, we've got a different answer for a different person.
Oh, okay.
Even with having three of the correct signatures on it.
I saw it.
No. They say no. Which is okay, I get it. You're defensive. But damn. I mean, I love my school, I love everything. But imagine having this on the 100th anniversary of the school. I mean, the logo built itself. And that's what I pitched. And,
What
were you pitching?
The championship game for Jones Stadium.
Oh, okay.
Well, Saturday's graduation, though.
Yeah.
So if you were asking that, they're going
to
see.
Well, this was before we had the date set, but I was trying to push it, and I think we could have been flexible with the date.
Hold down for a while.
Just
that burnt while he was talking. I was like,
yeah, I heard
that. Like, kind of like, oh, shit, I just burnt right into the freaking microphone.
I'm like, how loud does Boston have these freaking mics, man? I heard myself swallow again.
I know, me too.
I was sitting back here, I was like, wait a minute. Let me go check on them.
Yeah, man, we have a lot of fun. Try to keep it as less informal, least informal as possible. Just happy.
That's what works. It's all that works. Sports talk has become too structured.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Hanging out with the guys, talking sports. That's what it should be.
Which is probably why I never went back on any of the radio stations because I was not structured enough.
Yeah.
Where do you work at now, Chris?
My house.
But what else do you do?
I do. I've got to get through these business cards. Since I quit 9, I rebooted the Herald Post.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
And then I've got the original website, which is horizoncity.com.
And so you're all about Horizon. I'm in Horizon on the regular.
The reg?
Oh.
Just gigantic, man. Blew up. Once you put the loop out there and Zaragoza and all that stuff, just.
They need a connection, though. They need a connection to the loop higher north.
Yeah.
By Darrington. Well, they need Darrington to connect all the way over.
They're talking East Lake is going to continue straight through, and then right before you get to the high school, as you come off, East Lake is supposed to extend all the way almost to the high school,
mm-hmm.
and then do like a right-hand turn so it connects with Horizon Boulevard.
Okay.
But I don't know.
Darrington, that's the road past the loop, right? You're heading on I-10, you hit 375, and the next road to go into Horizon City?
East Lake.
Darrington is past that? I don't
know what Darrington is. Darrington intersects.
Gotcha.
About 10 minutes north of the I-10, though. It's way the hell up there.
They were asking me, Harold and the guys, apparently, I don't know if they're going to stay. They were asking me about the airport hill. I was like, no, I stay in Clint. It's up there with that Best Western there. And they can just take Darrington, which is the back road, to get there. But they weren't really being nice on price.
Except for the airport. I haven't been in
a prayer. I don't remember the last
time I was there. That's why you missed a show.
Damn. I got brawls in Atlanta.
Believe me, you had no idea how much I was missing the show last Tuesday.
That was a pretty good show. Since I found out you guys don't listen to the show,
you know, I went back. I was like, "How the fuck did I not listen to it?" It was the night we had Johnny on.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, "I listened to the show, but I fell asleep with like the last few minutes because I didn't hear the last 10 minutes."
Yeah.
And then I heard the what you talked about last time.
Our outtakes. We have a little bit of outtakes.
What's up, Coach? Not much. What's up? Yeah, he says we're thinking about it at this point. My wife says she can help run it, too, so we might be all right.
You know, how you doing this? Oh, man. Take two. Have them over there just in case. Take
Figure out how to get some cash out and then buy the supplies.
That's right, yeah. Oh, he's that guy.
How'd you do it?
I'd say Friday we just store it here and then we move it over. Because again, I'm gonna be there. I'm gonna be there at 2 to open it up, so we'll be good to go.
Ooh, wee, Mr. Man.
Just warm and cool down. I want to put everything in the bathrooms. Hey, is it, who's the? Are we going by record on home team? Or
I heard the top seed.
Yeah. Sit on your hands. All right, jerk
so they'll take the home side then, and they'll take the other. Okay, cool. All right. No, as soon as I hear from Angel.
Basil, yeah, you shut that door?
What door?
The main door coming in.
All
right. Yeah, well, I got to talk to you about our stalker.
Because today's what? Is today Wednesday?
Wednesday night, yes, sir.
Okay, so we should be getting the check and stuff from April tomorrow. So let's play it by ear. If we can't meet tomorrow, we can meet Friday night. Just to make sure, because I think at this point, we're pretty good with volunteers, and with my wife wanting to run the session, we should be good. Yeah, it's our guys.
Yeah, I know. We're not talking about it.
Okay. All right. Yeah, we're gonna be able to take the money out. So we gotta pay the refs out of the till too.
Some of them.
Dude, the other day.
Yeah. Well, no, they wanted to because they didn't want to wait to catch the check.
We threw a slant, and our guy caught it.
So. And so to take about check 5 tomorrow, yards. Destroy it. And
you haven't said hi to our fans.
Cool. Hello, fans.
All right, oh,
hello, fans.
Yeah.
Right. Fans. So the guy catches
the,
it,
I'm
and boom, and then the ball comes out and it rolls out. And then we recovered the fumble.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So then on one side of the field, the guy saying that's a fumble, and the guy that was right in front of calls it incomplete after the guy clearly took like 5 yards. And our point was, if it was incomplete, why didn't he call it as soon as it was incomplete?
Right,
why did he wait
to
see who had possession? And then as soon as the Reapers got possession, he called it incomplete.
So for the one person who's probably watching right now, because I don't know, I'm not looking at stats, so we're not going to go on yet. These refs kill these fucking games. Like, where do you all get these refs from?
It depends on the crew. I mean, at this point, we use the high school refs, and then they use their training crews with some of our team. So at this point, I think the worst crew that we had was the one for the championship game 2 years ago. And they've gotten better because we're taking it seriously. They take it seriously. Mm-hmm. But to me, this year, it seems like it may be the vibe of the game that they're going to. Like the problem that the Kings had with the 3 refs. Nobody wanted to go do it because they knew there's going to be trouble. Mm-hmm. When we played you guys, refs were fine. Mm-hmm. When we played Sunday, refs were fine. So it's a thing where we've got to manage expectations, and then we've got to make sure that they know that they're valued.
But where do those officials work at in high school games? Because I've never seen them.
Yeah.
And the guys that work the clock with me, they don't know who they are.
They're all at, what is it, TASO? At the state officiating something or other.
Okay.
But I see them when I do 600. I always see at least one or two of them. They apparently they know me because they've heard my voice.
Yeah.
So they listen. So even though it might not have been through crossover, I know I've seen them at the games. But they're getting better. We're getting first line crews, whereas before it was. Yeah. And then that game in Berlin was a straight up nightmare. I mean, I wasn't playing. I was doing my GM thing. I was on the side. They had a 6-person ref crew, and the linesman on my side was a female referee. And her hang up was behind the white line. Mm-hmm. We got one warning.
And also, can you come in here?
And 4 flags. Mm-hmm. 4 flags for sideline warnings. We've never seen that. So at the second half, I had the guys back way off the line, and it was me and Mondo. We were sitting there right there, and they threw a pass. We threw a pass to this side, and it got knocked out of bounds. And the referee tripped on the turf, looked at Mondo and I, almost on track, and threw a flag for sideline interference. I'd never seen a referee leave a game so quickly after that. Because I was gonna give her a piece of. I have never seen a crew that bad, and that was her obsession. Mm-hmm. I mean, she didn't call anything else except sideline violations. Wow. And the guys, it gets to your guys. It'll get to them. It's like, this ref.
She's bothered. We
played, so we know. Yeah. We know what it's like when we got crap referees.
I was pissed.
How you finally found out how to work your camera.
I can not format it by accident, so yes.
There we go.
I can do it on purpose, though.
If we go out to the game, will we be able to get down on the field, take some pictures, take some video, things like that?
Yeah, if you guys want to go, Midland's bringing play-by-play. Apparently, their color guy can't make it, so it's going to be me. So we're going to have the away coaches box. The rest is open. So if you guys should do a live show from there, whatever you guys want to do.
We can do it. We can broadcast live.
I can't guarantee stuff for this next couple weeks, but
well, no, I got you. Yeah. I got you. Yeah.
But, I was trying to get the NM Rush. I was trying to get that Artesia crew to do the TV broadcast. Mm-hmm. Did you watch any of their games?
Yeah, I did not.
It's awesome. It was a 2-man crew and a cameraman, and apparently they do punch on their either a laptop or a tablet, and yeah, it was pretty good.
Because if we can get the product cleaned up, because the reason why I stopped talking about it was because I drove out to Las Cruces. Okay, I live in Sequoia. I went, picked up my nephews from like Montana Vista.
It's a valid bitch. It really is. Like,
no, it's
a
very
valid bitch. I told one of
the players about him on Saturday. He thought, oh, yeah, that was
drove out to Las Cruces.
I don't blame him at all. Before
that. Well, that was that one. Yeah.
It was the fight game, the fight on the sideline game.
And I feel bad because it's the first game that I went to for the Kings. They've been asking me to go out there for a while. So. Sorry, Kings. But it was the first time that I had gone out there, and, it gets called at the half.
Yeah.
Well, that's a 2-hour trip.
Yeah, for nothing.
Yeah.
And see, with ours, and that's been the main thing I've tried to.
Because I can go to you guys. I'm supportive.
Yeah, you just come up the
road. Just up the road, yeah.
Go for it.
But that's one of the things we're going to deal with in the offseason is getting. Like, there's no reason for a team not to play. Mm-hmm. There's no reason. I don't care. And I'm talking from first person experience. When I was coaching in junior high, 2 years, defensive coordinator, 0-16. Not once did the kids ever think about quitting. Never.
I coached 4th and 5th grade girls basketball. They never quit.
Yeah. I had a team when I was coaching basketball famous. We went the regular, and I told them, I said, girls, we're not going to win too many games regular season. Mm-hmm. You guys are playing for the playoffs because everybody's in. So just get good. I'm not going to yell at you. I'm not going to bench you. Everybody plays. We get good. Mm-hmm. So by the time we hit the championship tournament, we went all the way to the championship game. Because they had gotten better. Mm-hmm. But nobody quit on me. I cannot imagine adult males not wanting to play football. Mm-hmm. I don't care what the odds are. I'm trying to get back into play. I cannot imagine these guys thinking, no, we'll tell the coach we're going to show up. We're not going to show up. How do you wake up with that?
A part of me wants to get back and play, but I know my wife would fucking
do that. Do you have bad aspirations too, man? I tell you lined up at tight end.
See that? Yeah, I don't think
we'll
bring that back up.
No, I told him, I said, look, I may not be able to do much, but on those games when we're traveling, and we're traveling with a 25-man squad, I'm a starter. Not by any stretch of the imagination am I a starter. But second quarter, somebody, you need to hold somebody out for the third.
Spell
somebody for two series and go.
Get yourself in a few plays and get the hell out of it.
That's what I did at Dallas. I mean, that's what was cool is that, like, hell. I played at Dallas.
Are you trying to be a superstar?
Yeah. The Cowboys, yeah.
Yeah, right. AT&T.
But, it was fun.
Saturday, can you go out there?
This Saturday?
Let's see the channel. And we'll set something up. We'll see if we can broadcast live. The shootout live. Those of you like
from the Rio Grande League, the Rio Grande Bowl 2.
Damn.
Well, see, that was the thing. That's why I cut it down because it was like Rio Grande.
Sounds like no.
So let's call it the Grande. Call it the Grande Bowl. It sounds.
That sounds like something you order at Taco Bell.
Rio Grande Bowl.
Bowl.
No, it's
like
Rio Grande Bowl. It's the Rio Grande Bowl.
This bowl is Grande.
Mm-hmm. Fuck this radio. I like Grande.
That's true.
I saw that they have a thing on a tune in.
Through Rio's Radio.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we can do odd stuff.
Do any of you guys know somebody that I can go to? Because, like I said, I have that issue with my website.
The Weebly you want to go to? WordPress?
Yeah, I want to go to WordPress.
I told you about
WordPress.
That.
That's what I mean, the exact person you want to speak with.
WordPress is cake.
Yeah.
Well, no, because I...
Is it? My past my post is all online. Yeah, Chris runs it.
My website is powered through Weebly.
Uh-huh.
I sound like I gave him a shout out. I'm not doing that. But it's, you know, they're the ones who I got it from. And I want to move it over to WordPress because WordPress can do so much more. How would I be able to do that?
Okay, so you're using the Weebly template.
Yeah.
I think it's portable. I think you're gonna have to rebuild on WordPress because the conversion is crazy. Mm-hmm. But once you're on WordPress, you're done. Okay. I mean, WordPress is scalable. It's easy to code. It's easy to change. It's easy. That's the Herald Post and all of my websites are WordPress.
Look at this fucking flyer.
What's everybody looking at me?
I'm looking at that.
Boss, silly.
You weren't even looking at me.
Get those chopsticks like you did and get them.
Do your Miyagi and get that fly out of here.
Miyagi sensei, please.
Yeah, more likely, I'll just have to rebuild.
Yeah, just rebuild. It shouldn't take that long. Just keep it and then you swap it over. But
I already bought the domain. The domain.
Yeah.
Deep done.
Tipton Sports. I like it. What I want to do is do, like, I guess basically shoot up. That's basically what I want to put up on. Because I use so much more of that.
I use Mixler as my broadcast app,
mm-hmm.
and it's right here. I just hook up my headset to it, and I do all my games from right here. It takes them out live, and then
for the 600?
No, for Horizon.
Oh, Horizon.
Because I do all the sports mm-hmm. there, and I've been doing baseball games for 2 years now. And I just once it goes out live, and then as soon as I'm done, I stop it. It uploads it. By the time I get home, the code's ready. I just embed the code, and they get the replay.
Mm-hmm. Wow!
Yeah! Boom!
If you don't mind, I'll give you a call.
I'll give you the copy.
Yeah, you get this card, right?
Yeah, first thing in my wallet.
Okay.
Cool. You got one.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, if you check it out, I mean, I've got all the stuff I've done is archived there, and it's easy. And I think the next step for us is for the Herald Post is that High Desert Radio, Broad City Radio, is going to become an actual internet radio station,
mm-hmm.
just so we can do broadcasts, and we're probably going to end up with 40 to 50 songs on our playlist and just buy a license and go with it. Because
deal with local bands and have them send you your best stuff.
We thought about it, and right
like
now,
yeah.
The big thing that's underserved right now, and I didn't quite believe my wife, and now that I'm
never listening, believe listening, your wife.
It's actual. Like,
Dusty's watching this, by the way.
I'm sure. Believe your wife.
They call it prime country, which is country from the 80s. And the early 90s, nobody's playing it.
That's my wheelhouse.
Jenny loves that shit.
So,
Sunday nights is playing that's what she listens to the most because she loves it. This is the good country. Side. I don't know the difference.
So I've got about 40 songs picked out. You know, George Strait, everybody all the way through.
Jorge Derecho.
Everybody set. And you just put it on a 3-hour loop and we break in with Herald Post News. And when we have sports on it.
That's awesome. Yeah, definitely.
I know a sports show.
Let's do your sports.
We have a sports show for you.
Yeah. I could do a sports show.
Okay. I don't know if you've seen it, but we've got Talk Nerdy to Me, and you guys are pretty close to that right now.
Mm-hmm. Talk what?
Talk Nerdy to Me. Have you seen it? It's Jack and Troy.
You guys are on iTunes?
They've got it on iTunes, but it's on Facebook and it's on YouTube.
Oh,
and
wow.
It's
Talk Nerdy to Me.
My wife is telling me that
one. Nerdy baby.
Have you heard? You need to hear the theme. That's exactly the. It's an exact parody.
Yeah, it's off that song. Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna be calling you later on.
That's fine. It's easy. It's.
Thank you, Will.
Welcome,
this man. Do you know how much fucking connections this man has?
Dude, he drops a name stuck in every show. How do I not know?
I mean, we're stuck at three right now.
Yeah, we're only stuck at three, which is a shocker.
Oh, I have three friends.
Three friends. Three shocker. I like that. You all right, Basil?
Yeah,
he's not one of my friends.
He's off tonight.
He is off. I think something's up here.
You're right, Basil.
Yeah.
Well, he's all right.
Are you sure? You don't seem yourself.
You better be.
Did you get laid and she gave you the clap?
Do you have bras in Atlanta?
Maybe he's menstruating.
Menstruating.
No,
it's myriad.
No, I just got chlamydia this morning.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We just want to make sure
that's it.
He's all right.
That's it. It'll be gone in 2 weeks. Man. Just take
a
shot. Get that rod.
We've all done it. We've all been there.
You close when you pee.
So I'm going to have to go to the restroom because it was like my third, fourth one.
Good.
All right. I'll go before it's out.
Yeah. Oh.
We'll talk about the WNBA and see how long it
is. No, it's going to be like that. That's actually a good idea. I might as well.
Let's see. Grab this cake.
Grab that.
Yeah, I think that this game, if I have an, if I played my media cards right, you got anybody in, I think we're gonna be okay.
With what?
Just getting people out there, getting the media out there to recognize us.
I hope so, man.
I mean, at least for the guys, you know, they're the ones who lose, you know, they leave, they do their, they work all day and they go out and practice, they don't get any recognition for it. And that's what it's about. I mean, that's why you're playing.
I just love that they do it because they love playing. You know what I mean? I mean, they're doing it for because they love the game. I don't know how much they love, you know, the, I mean, they love the media attention, I'm sure.
I think that the next step we need to take, it's just a matter of pay the players and whatever else you're doing. And after you pay your expenses, stadium, whatever else, that money goes into a pot. And whatever that pot is, whoever is signed up, by the time the roster's locked down, that's how many ways you split it. So it behooves the teams to get as much money there as possible. I mean, it might be $125, but for, you know, you get your investment back. You get your helmet.
See, and I've always thought for the players, it would just be like $50 a game or something, you know? Just something for them to have something to play for, like have their skin in the game, you know? Because right. That's the reason I think you have so many issues. Like, if a guy is going to get $50, even if it's just $50,
he'll show up.
He'll show up.
Yeah.
And he'll show up to practice and say, you need to go to 2 practices this week and play and get $50.
Yeah.
So, and if you get ejected, you're not getting paid. You know what I mean? And then I think that totally changes.
That brings in the player that's committed in a different way. Right. And it brings the players that are already committed. It lets them know that their commitment is going to be rewarded.
Yeah. I've always thought that, too.
Yeah, it's there needs to be a compensation for it.
How is the game going?
I haven't seen the score yet since I turned it back on. Last time I checked, it was 50-43 Cleveland.
Really? Mm-hmm. Cleveland?
Mm-hmm. Cleveland.
Chauncey Billups.
Of course, my phone there.
He's still playing?
60-46 now.
No, Chauncey Billups hasn't played in like 3 years.
He's doing a live question and answer session for Sports Center on Snapchat.
Gotcha.
Nobody remembers you, Chauncey. Give it up.
I remember him. Played for Colorado. Won some championships with them.
The Pistons?
He won a championship with the Pistons. And then they got that work by the Spurs. Boom.
Or Ben Wallace.
Boom. That dude was awesome.
That dude was awesome.
He's already kicked off the Malice in the Palace. Him and Artest.
That was amazing. Don't give them a shout out yet.
Okay.
Well, luckily, I can edit this stuff out. I can't do it live now.
You jerk.
Right in the Reggie Bush.
Right in the Reggie Bush.
Chris Babcock's like, I should have fucking never came.
Yeah.
This is the best 2 hours of his life right now.
I'll tell you, this is the way you need to run. This is how you need to have Sports Fox. Roll it out there, figure out a way to get phone calls and rag on them. That's the way to do it.
Put it up to the mic. Panda. Diggity! Did you say diggity?
Panda.
Nah. Panda. Okay, we'll let this play for a little bit.
This is the oddest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Panda.
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 All right. And with that, we also have, I don't know a nickname for you. I gotta come up with a nickname for you.
Panda!
Your beard is almost as epic.
I was going down.
You look like I mean, it's a little darker.
There was no way I was ever going to go on a flight with the way that my beard. Bob's better. Bob's. Intense. Would you like? I've got special.
I was on the Buzz Adams Kaley Q Money Show.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
Yeah, okay. So, everybody, a fart or something? Like, what's wrong? I didn't have a headset on, so I had no idea Chris was talking to me. That's all I remember Chris. And he was like talking like, what the hell is Chris Rappa?
I was like, Latoria, it's natural for you to look over.
Yeah. Put your hands up. Okay.
Wouldn't it be like, I mean, that's an awesome story, bro. But,
thanks. I'm full of them.
But wouldn't Chris Babcock be the fifth name that he dropped?
I think so.
Yeah, we'll call that five. What do you think? We'll call that five.
You know what? I'm honored to be able to be a name that is dropped. I mean, the fact that I'm to that point, that goes up there.
So he told me, he's like, well, Chris Babcock's interested in coming. I was like, whoa, we'll let him come.
Talk about porn problems.
And then Vossel took it to a whole other level. That's why he knows he's been really shy around this. The stuff
That's why he didn't look at me in the eye.
Right. Exactly. You take the Babcock.
Special. With cheese.
Put a lot of shiz on that.
He's got brows in
his with this last name? It started early and often.
Good.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they've been saying something that I've been called like for a long time. My last name is Tipton. Just the tits.
Yeah.
Slow down, just the tip.
Every derivation of it, and it's.
Let me just put in the tip. Just the tip. So they got balls in Atlanta.
Yeah, you do. Have you been following the NBA? The NBA Finals action that we had. That word loosely.
Warriors sweep. I'm calling it.
Do you think the Cavs have what it takes to series, or do you think this is just we finally came home and we're going to lose the next two?
Is
oh, really? Oh, you're not that old. Come on.
If you're a Golden State Warrior fan and you don't know Tim Hardaway, you're not a Golden State Warrior fan. That's basically.
I don't even know who Chris Mullins is.
Yeah. The fade, the buzz cut. I have a Celtics story. You're a big Celtics fan, said?
Big Celtics.
You remember Chris Herron?
Chris Herron played in the late 80s? About 89, 90, 91?
2000s. That was my cousin.
No.
Nah. Yeah, like literally second cousin, but like cousin.
That's a name drop.
Yeah, that's number six.
That's a good name drop, though. I mean,
that's a legit name drop. His cousin played for the Celtics.
My dad met Bill Wall. He was renting a U-Haul.
Really?
Name drop.
Yeah.
So my cousin.
But I mean, honestly, how often do you get to meet a Hall of Fame?
You don't. I mean, it's Bill Wall. I mean, UCLA, everything.
So my cousin, he's playing for the. He's actually from Fall River, which is right there in the whole Boston area. I'm talking about. He was a fantastic basketball player. His father was 10. So, my cousin had an addiction problem, and so he liked to meet his dealer in the parking lot at the Celtics Stadium before the games.
At the Garden,
which in his warm-up jersey, in the parking lot, waiting for the pillow guy to show up or whatever. So, obviously, kind of washed out. He played well, but the drugs kind of took him. So, he ended up in Italy, and while he was in Italy, he passed out at a stoplight with a needle in his arm.
Ouch.
Whoa. Yeah, and so that kind of ended his basketball career, but he turned it around for addiction.
Oh, wow.
And stuff like that. So he kind of made him a positive, and he's done really, really well with that.
That's awesome, man.
That's a good story.
Basketball teams are.
I don't really have one. If it would be anybody, it'd be the Celtics.
Yeah, Rawls in Atlanta.
The Hawks.
There's no way you're a Hawks fan.
Anything but the Spurs. Sorry. All my friends love the Spurs, so I have to hate the Spurs. It wasn't just you, Tipton. Like, all my friends love the Spurs.
You see, people have asked me.
I have been a hardcore Warriors fan since 2015.
I've been a hardcore Warriors fan since they defeated the Oklahoma City Thunder in the 2016.
73 wins. 73-74. One of them.
I love when Oklahoma City, they've always been in the league. Really? They have?
That's my team, Chris.
Back 79.
There we go. 79.
But yeah, that's the best way to fight that. Oh man, Oklahoma City, yeah. Hey, remember when they played in 86? Yeah, Oklahoma City was rocking in 86.
Sean Kemp?
They were not.
You remember Gary Payton?
The glove?
Yeah. Detlef Schrempf.
Yep.
That's awesome because that reminds me of
this.
Probably like
and having like these huge like near fist fights in English because there was this little cadre of Philadelphia 76ers fans. Dr. J and everybody, they're like, yeah, the 76ers. This was like 81. They're like, yeah, the Sixers. I was like, really? The 76ers. Who else on that team can you mention besides Dr. J? And this was the reason it was. That's all we got to watch. I mean, that was on Channel 4. You got to see all seven games. We went seven games. But what was weird about that is that at least two of the middle games were always on at lunch.
Yeah. Really? Different time.
And I remember when I was in high school, I actually got a note from my counselor to go to the library so I could watch Celtics play. And it was right after lunch.
That's awesome.
Coolest counselor ever.
I will say this, though, and it just popped in my mind. That was before the three-point line.
No.
Come on, wasn't that like 81, 82?
No. 3-point line was there. This was 80. See, I graduated in 86.
Oh.
So it was. All right. It was a new thing.
A new thing.
Feels good not to be old, huh?
Yeah, it does.
This guy.
Once again, the second youngest person in this room. Awesome. But I get asked a lot because with my age, people think I automatically became a Spurs fan whenever Tim Duncan got drafted. They won the championship in 99. Blah blah blah. I was actually originally a Bulls fan because I was born on Michael Jordan's birthday as a child. I was actually born in his rookie year. So the first time he retired, I wanted to, I was like, well, let me see what other teams are out there. And I saw David Robinson. And, that guy looked like he was cut out of a
Admiral.
Comedy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And ever since then, like, there was the days of Antoine Carr and Vinny Del Negro and J.R.
Vinny Del Negro.
Yeah. Avery Johnson.
By the way, I will do my name drop here. Vinny Del Negro followed me on Twitter.
Really? How'd that happen?
I don't know. He must have followed the wrong guy, but he followed me, and I will take it.
There you go. Smart man.
And see, the thing I don't like after them that they lost to the Flint Tropics. But they, nine times they said, What year was that? But I've got this really good memory. But in the early 70s, I remember we would get the NBA game of the week and then we'd get the ABA game of the week. So here regionally, that's what you would get. You'd get a Spurs. So I understand the connection to the Spurs. Five championships now, six?
Yeah, five.
So they're good. I mean, legitimately, you can say they're probably one of the top five teams in the NBA. I mean, legitimately now.
A lot of people don't realize the Spurs actually have the highest win percentage out of any of the NBA teams. And that kind of does, to me, that kind of percentage goes in NBA history is the San Antonio Spurs, the Phoenix Suns.
Yeah.
Really?
And then the LA Lakers.
Really?
As weird as that is, it because Boston came across some hard ties after Bird left?
Yeah, that was, there's been a couple of, right after the 50s, there's a short segment. They have like short segments of just being horrible. And this last one, after Bird, all the way to the 08 championship, it was.
I'll say this though, they have a bright future ahead of them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They've got some players on the team. Isaiah Thomas.
Yep.
He's like maybe 5'1".
Maybe.
Have a good day.
My son was so pissed that they lost. I was like, it's okay. We don't want to go into the playoffs not ready. I said, this is good. This is experience. This is the same way we did it. 81, 83, then we can get up there and then we can start knocking people off and go on.
They really wasted a lot of time hanging on to Antoine Carter, or not Antoine Walker, in my mind. He was a decent player, but they could have traded him for something else. You know, tried to rebuild around Paul Pierce a little earlier.
He went broke, didn't he? He had all kinds of financial problems.
He was playing in Puerto Rico in like a rec league.
Puerto Rico, poor guy.
But and that was the thing is it that my you know he really didn't understand that, and having lived through the transition from the party and doing all this didn't work, and then finally winning and you know getting close in 07, winning in 08, and then getting onto a more stable where the Celtics can actually have some leverage. He didn't understand why are you gonna let Garnett go. I said, because we don't want the 40-year-old Garnett on our team.
He'll play till he's 60. That guy, he's been in the league forever.
But he can't. Is he gonna be good enough for what Celtic basketball needs to be? And it's not. That's where it stops.
Yeah.
You don't need a 40-year-old powerful.
Yeah.
Unless you're Duncan.
Duncan.
But San Antonio, you know what? I give a lot of people grief. They had that Ghost Borgos on the
GSG.
That hashtag Ghost Spurs Go. I gave my guys so much.
I may have used that a couple hundred thousand times.
I looked at it. I was like, what is Ghost Spurgo? Is that like some sort of. I'll have the Ghost Spurgo.
He's calling your team snails.
There we go. Because Tony.
So, didn't he diss that girl, the beautiful woman?
Tony Parker can diss whoever he wants.
He did. He dated
Eva Longoria.
There it is. What a jerk. That beautiful lady. She's wonderful.
Evan Longoria is her brother, and he's a Yankees fan. So there you go. He's not really her brother.
Where are we going with this?
I never knew that.
Tony Parker. I think that jerk. She's beautiful.
She's probably bottom three on hottest woman ever.
I was gonna say, I mean, he cheats on her. That's what she said.
Wow, that's gonna stay. There we go. But we'll get back to the NBA finals. We went a little tangent there.
Do go on tangents.
Atlanta, I just can't believe Atlanta. You know what? Listening to, and it's so hard to listen to, even with SiriusXM, you get a chance to listen to some Boston games. Listening to the series 3 years ago when they were playing Atlanta.
Johnson?
God, that was the most annoying broadcast ever. I mean, I was to the point where because you can't find the home broad, you can't find. Highlight Factory, really? And he used that. It's like, did you trademark it? Because every other word out of it was the Highlight Factory. Oh, what a great shot for the Highlight Factory.
And he was like, I'm so witty and smart. I want to keep.
Okay, yeah.
And as a Red Sox fan, I have to point out what's the winningest team in the 21st century?
Oh, Red Sox! Hey. That's another one.
Let's go, Boston.
All your championships, multiply them by three, and you still haven't met us.
So you also a Patriots fan?
And he met my mom, and he was from Boston, from the Boston area. And my Christmases and summers. So we'd go up there, and I'd get a chance to listen to, in the summer, it was a Red Sox. It was awesome. Because down here, it was, we got a chance one day, but.
I love the Dodgers.
Yeah, we're Dodgers fans, but I feel you.
But over there, you know, you got the Red Sox. So then if we'd go up in the winter, it was, and this is when the Patriots sucked. I mean, this is like, the Patriots were like, you know,
Tony Easton.
6-8 and stuff like that. They were just horrible. Nobody cared.
I actually love that uniform.
That's an awesome uniform. Awesome. It's just so, they were to me, like the Patriots growing up, it's like, oh, they're a bunch of losers.
Jeff George played with them, like, towards the end of his career or something like that.
So,
George?
No Patriot, not a Patriots fan, but.
Who's your team?
For football?
Cowboys.
There it is! Winner, finally!
All right.
We can agree on one thing.
Okay,
and that's the other thing. It's Bruins. It's the Boston Bruins. So it's like always on the hockey side. But as far as we're concerned, one of my first memories was watching Super Bowl V, Colts and the Cowboys.
How old are you?
Whoa!
The Super Bowl with with my family and watching the Cowboys and watching them lose, and they were such a good team. And now Angel, the owner of the Armor, he said I read a book a long time ago, and I found that book in my uncle's bookcase, and it's called Next Year's Champions. And it talks about the 67-68 Dallas Cowboys season when nobody liked them. I mean, like, legit, they were like the losers. And they were like losing the playoffs.
Dallas Texans?
No, they were the actual Cowboys. Ah. And it talks about how they were coming out of the Texans' success and how they finally got over that hump by sending them to Kansas City. And it's just so interesting to read that. And then remembering Super Bowl V when the Cowboys played. And I was like, yeah, that's a good team. And then Staubach, and it just went from there. So
that was the reason why they started getting the moniker of America's team.
Right.
Because they were always next year's champion. They lost in so many championship games. Green Bay killed
them. Oh, man. You should, and again, if you can find this book, it's called Next Year's Champion.
Ice Bowl.
Oh, but the Ice Bowl, there's a chapter talking about the Ice Bowl and then coming after that. Like, everybody knows about the Ice Bowl, but talking about the flight home and how there were people that were, you know, Don Meredith was in the back kicking back, and he was, we got next year. And just the dynamic of that team coming off of that loss. I mean, now it's a historic loss, but back then it was just a loss, you know? Yeah. And then just talking about how that team progressed. If you can find it at a used bookstore, it's an awesome read. If you're a Cowboys fan, it's you need to have it. But if you're a football fan, it gives you an insight. You're in the locker room during these games, and it's awesome. Wow.
Cool story about the Ice Bowl that I saw. It was so cold out there, and back then, everybody had bands. You'd have the band. The marching band was kind of a big deal, so everybody got to watch the band. Well, there's a trumpeter during the Ice Bowl who went out there and was blowing his trumpet. His lips stuck to the trumpet, and when he pulled it off, he ripped his lips off.
Oh,
that's how friggin' cold it was. But back then, men were men. You know, they would do things like that.
He kept playing the damn trumpet. Yeah,
exactly. Right. He kept playing.
And Will knows him.
Yeah.
What's his name? Drop it.
Tony
Drop it.
Garcia.
There we go.
Good friend of
mine. Yeah, that sounds like somebody from
Tony
Wisconsin.
Lipless Garcia.
Without lips.
Tony the Lip.
Tony the Lip.
Tony Winky Face.
Tony No
Lips.
It's his defense. Tony Romo of Wisconsin.
Hey!
Take it back, Montez.
Well, I'm going to harp here a little bit as a Dallas Cowboys fan, okay?
That's harp.
We've been absolute garbage for 20 years, right?
Yeah.
20 years?
I think it's 17. Years. No, 18. 20 years.
It was 1995.
96.
Yeah, 21.
96.
Wait, we won one of our last games, 2003, when Romo didn't hold that ball down?
Our last playoff win was in 2011.
Okay, so let's say we've been garbage for 9 years, or whatever. I'm not a captain of math. 27 years.
He said there would be no math tonight.
We haven't won a championship since 1996, as you said. Okay.
That's what counts. That's what you're looking for.
That's all it is.
Nobody's looking to make the playoffs unless you're the Browns.
That's not a win.
Or the Texans.
Brock Lobster.
But you look at it. Teams have just now caught up to what the Dallas Cowboys did for those first, 40-some-odd years. Because they went to 8 Super Bowls. Well, now people are tied with it. The Broncos just tied them for the most Super Bowl appearances last year. Okay? The Broncos still haven't tied them in Super Bowl wins. The Steelers took, 11 years to beat them in their Super Bowl wins? So, I mean, for all you Cowboys haters out there, it's like, that's literally all I got to say. That's all I got to say. Boston,
we need you
a Cowboys
follow.
Fan.
Oh. You tell me to, yeah.
There we go. That should be the answer for everything. That should be the answer for everything.
Tell me too. Yeah.
Go Cowboys right now.
See, I can tell you, and here's where all of the other anti-Cowboy stuff starts, because I was right there during that, and again, Debbie with my age. The Steelers and the Cowboys went back and forth during the 70s. I can remember friends of mine in third grade, because their dad hated the Cowboys. And again, that was the only game you could really watch. You either watch them or the Oilers.
And
they would end up hating the Cowboys and liking the Steelers, which makes no sense. You're in Texas. I mean, it's like
liking a front runner. You got bras in Atlanta.
it's like Hank Hill said, I'm a Cowboys fan, but I like the Oilers. You like the Oilers because if the Cowboys were going to suck at some point, you could always cheer for the Oilers.
Warm mood.
Because they would beat the Steelers. Mm-hmm. But that's where it started. You know, now that I remember this one girl in third grade, she was like, oh, yeah, Steelers. I was like, who's the quarterback? Yeah, Steelers. it was all that she saw from her dad. But now her kids are like, Roethlisberger, and they've got the championship. So now
Lee Mays.
I just never understood it. Never understood it.
I have a Warren Moon story. Can I drop that name too?
That's number 7.
Now, is it a real Warren Moon story, or is it like a porn star named Warren Moon?
Little column A, little column B. My grandma listened to this story, so no. I don't think. My grandmother is in California.
Hold on. I need to say a little joke here first, right?
Yeah, walk that dog back. Leave her out of this. My grandmother's a saint, goddammit.
She played middle South linebacker. She played middle linebacker for the Akron Zips.
Yeah. Go. Just go.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. So my grandmother is in Los Angeles at the airport meeting my aunt, and there's this really big black guy walking down, I guess, the hall or wherever.
That's how most porn start.
Right. God damn it. So she's walking down, and a couple guys are kind of like messing with him, and he's kind of pushing people away. And she walks up to him, and she goes, "Are you a basketball player?" And Warren Moon goes, "No, ma'am, I play football." And sign this for me with his number. I still have that at the old office.
Oh, that's cool, man.
That is cool.
Isn't that kind of cool?
Yeah.
Do you play basketball? No, ma'am.
I didn't know your grandmother was British.
Oh, she
Do you play basketball? She's like Downton Abbey.
Yeah. Crikey.
Me?
So why didn't you become an Oilers fan?
Here against the Cowboys, I'd get spanked.
Oh, okay.
So I learned early on when I was a child.
And now we know why Jericho's going to be a Cowboy.
Hey. You know what I mean?
Actually, I don't know. I mean, PC, I don't think I can.
Oh, you do anymore. Know. You can.
Yeah.
You can and you will.
It's beneficial to him.
I'm not going to go Adrian Peterson style.
No,
I'm
not also Adrian Peterson. Just a little.
How was it? Kid 3 or something like that, 2?
I don't know.
Well, I'm saying names.
Go ahead.
My bad. I'll talk
about
Boston. Yeah, sure. So, this little kid, I don't know what it was, but like 2:30 in the friggin' morning, he wakes up and like he doesn't tell us he's awake, he doesn't do anything. But he comes in the bedroom and he just stares at me.
That's a soundproof room when you can hear him.
I roll over and I look up and I'm like, oh my god! There's this little kid just sitting there staring at me at like 2:30.
Kids do that.
They do that and they just come in like, I don't know if he was like waiting for me to wake up or needed something. Just staring at me.
Jericho will walk
over. Wet myself. I was so scared.
Jericho will walk over to my side of the bed and he'll stand there. And like I could feel him there because I'm such a light sleeper. And then it's just.
No.
I mean, 3 in the morning, you kind of get freaked out a little bit. You know it's your son, but you freak out.
Get the shit out of me.
So I choke slammed him.
But, yeah. What did he learn?
He learned to keep doing it. Yeah. He likes to get chokeslammed, apparently.
Yeah, so that same kid.
Note to his future wife, if she's going to listen to this podcast, because, you know, we cross timelines.
Just chokeslam him and everything will be fine. That's how I handle my business. So the same little kid, right? I'm dating this, you know, girl and everything. And, like, a few months later, we hear this, like, rustling around, like, 3 o'clock in the morning or something like that. So we're kind of freaking out. We go into his room, and this little kid is sleepwalking, but he's just standing in his toy box.
That's
just like that.
Shit.
Holy shit, we watched it. Oh my god! You know what I mean? He's just staring like that. Little kids, man, they're creepy.
That would have been like some, you know, sci-fi scary movie shit that I definitely would have wanted.
I was like, yeah, yep. This point, is your kid, babe.
At that point, I'm like, you know, you had a good run. but your son is from like the ring.
And yeah, I'm out here. Exactly. Little Exorcist baby. Love the kid, love the girl, but man, creepy as hell.
Bossel, if you were in that situation, what would you do?
Mason.
Why would I be sleepwalking into a crib?
No, toy box.
Wait.
Child's in a toy box.
Oh, wait. Oh, as no, his little part. My bad. I thought I was a kid. Never mind.
Bossel?
Hi.
It's too early for this stuff.
You're too early.
That's what she said.
Hey.
I don't want to go there, but yeah. Also, thank you, though. Thank you for that amazing input that you always give us.
That's what I'm here for.
Keep us on track.
You know what we were supposed to talk about when we came back from that break?
The NBA Finals.
The NBA Finals.
I thought we did.
No.
We did for like 2 seconds.
We spoke about why he doesn't like, you know, why Chris is East Coast biased.
Ah.
And then I went to the Spurs and you guys went off on something else. Michael Wants has been quiet as hell over here for the last maybe 20 minutes. I don't know. What's going on with him?
How's that game going?
They're losing by 23.
That was you? Your mom is alive.
No.
Son!
They're losing by 23.
How many points does LeBron have? That's my question. Because anytime
715.
Again, going back,
Coach LeBron,
calling back all the way to the early conversation when he was with the Heat. Anytime that the Heat needed to get that first game won or get back in the system, he'd go off for 35, 40 points. But from a team standpoint, you cannot sustain that over a 5-game series.
And you see, and that's what I was going to go at. Whenever the Spurs lost to the Heat in the finals, it wasn't because of the doing of what LeBron James did. It was that miracle shot that Ray Allen.
Yeah.
The Spurs, right. The Spurs should have had that championship game.
Daggers.
But, you know, whenever they basically annihilated the Heat the following year, it was because they said, we'll let LeBron get his. We'll just shut down everybody else.
Yeah.
And now you notice that's exactly what Golden State did last year. That's what they're doing this year because LeBron James had, 30 points in the last game?
Yeah, he's going to average that per game because that's the kind of player he is.
He's a phenomenal, phenomenal basketball player.
LeBron used to muscle his way to the basket, you know, a few years ago. Now it's a little different. He's kind of not finessing, but he used to just overpower people. He was overstrengthening people. See, now it's different.
And this is the thing that I've seen from watching Game 1 and Game 2. The Cavaliers were really quick to put LeBron James on Steph Curry, and he was shut down Steph Curry. There's no doubt about that because he's just so big. But what they give up is defensive rebounding. Yep.
Because he's out front. There's nobody there to clean the boards.
So Draymond Green was having a field day. Andrew Bogut, of all people, killed it. Career-high 15 points in the playoffs. 15 points.
They have to resign him.
15 points. You don't need Andrew Bogut.
King James has scored 24 points tonight. J.R. Smith has 20. And then Kyrie Irving has 25.
How many assists? How many assists?
And he leads all scores. Kyrie Irving's leading all scores. LeBron has 6 assists and 9 rebounds.
Ooh, getting close to that triple double.
All around.
LeBron James has to be the best all-around player since Magic Johnson. I'm not gonna say he's better than Magic, but he's been.
I agree with that.
And this is the thing that bothers me. People want to compare him to Jordan. Jordan was a better, you know, just one-on-one go at it. LeBron is more like Magic.
Magic, exactly.
More like Magic than anybody else.
But I think he can rebound better.
Oh, yeah.
Because of his size, you know what I mean?
Jordan put the team on his shoulders and go win a championship.
You know,
he'd have the flu and he'd go win a championship.
You don't realize how much of a freakish athlete LeBron James is until you see him post up someone like Steph Curry. I do remember, he is 6'8", 260.
Right.
But he's 260 of muscle. You know what I mean? Not 260 like me, but 260 of muscle.
And to that stat right there, if you see the same thing that Heat would happen with the Heat. You have other people go into the 20s, and they're kind of distributing that ball out. But again, him by himself is not going to win a game. So I think maybe we're going 6 games with this one, but it's going to be the Warriors. I just can't see them coming back after this game.
I don't even know if the loss of Kevin Love actually helps the Cavaliers.
I think it does.
You know what I mean?
And the only reason why I think it helps out the Cavaliers that they lose Kevin Love is because he had 0 playoff experience whenever he was with Minnesota. Mm-hmm. You look at it last year, he goes out, you know, early in the playoffs because of Kelly Olynyk, which was probably the best move I've ever seen in basketball. But Kelly Olynyk basically dislocates his shoulder, he can't play. You know, he has no experience, and he's in this finals where he's got so much pressure
on him. It looks like it's bigger than him.
It is. It looks like it's bigger than the entire Cavs roster. Outside of LeBron James, who can kind of keep things in. But you need to have those role players, and I don't think Kevin Love knows his role.
Kevin Love comes in, and the Cavaliers are a slower, less cohesive team, because he inserts himself into. And again, I'm not a big Cleveland game watcher, but when I've seen him, he posts up and then he kind of crosses over, and it's just missing it. And then defensively, he's a half step off.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I think that it helps. I think it helps them that he's out, because then you can put in somebody that's a half a step quicker. And they may not
like J.R. Smith tonight, who has 20 points.
But $5 bill tattoo on his neck.
This is where I think Cleveland messes up. Is I don't think Kevin Love is a power forward.
No, he's not.
I think he's a 5. He needs to be at the 5 because he needs to be at the rim.
Yeah.
Because as we've seen, he's an amazing offensive and defensive rebounder. Leave him at the 5. Get rid of Tristan Thompson, because I don't know what Tristan Thompson brings to the game. I mean, how he got a $90 million contract is beyond me. Well, bring in Shumpert.
Well, Denine's bring got 13 rebounds, and I think that's what they look for in him. Did that's they, pretty much it.
What's the score?
What? How many fouls does
97, 20, 97,
70. Like, come on now.
99-74 Cavs.
How much time? 25-point lead.
7 minutes. 7 minutes.
How many fouls does Bogut have? Because that's the only reason why I could see Tristan Thompson getting that many rebounds is Andrew two. Bogut being a foul for
Bogut. He's got two.
What about Green?
Green has three.
Wow. An anomaly.
Yeah.
Because Tristan Thompson is not a good offensive player. He'll get but he doesn't. Shumpert at three, yeah. J.R. Smith.
Will be able to come in.
Exactly. But listen, it's like 48%.
Yeah, I don't know. We grew up in a time where Jordan was averaging like 50.
Points in the game.
Engager.
I wish we had
twice.
I don't know him. I don't. I'm not king of El Paso like you.
Yes.
Oh, we have Matt Williams coming on the program next week.
Yes. And No. What Vossel said.
No.
Vossel said real quietly. So we're going to edit this out.
That's going to have to edit out.
So,
just.
To say, and I want to make my point.
Well, the funny thing about it was just basically fat.
No, listen.
Fappin' Will Herring.
That's my other nickname.
But go ahead and go with this Jesse story. I'll edit all that out. Continue with Jesse Pettit.
So, Pettit, she is going to be the assistant coach taking it over for Decker. She used to play for the UTEP Miners with Coach Cross. Coach Cross, obviously, her coach. And she's awesome. She has plenty of experience. She's going to do great. She'll pop right in for Decker and take the team to the next level.
Because we're going to win a Conference USA championship.
We're going to win an NCAA. Thank you. Tell
okay.
Them, Tim.
National championship.
I don't know if you heard the podcast or not. Everything UTEP does, national championship.
Everything.
Tim shoots for the stars.
That's what I do.
Actually, solar systems beyond the stars.
Exactly. I shoot for galaxies.
You have to aim high because then you pass your expectations.
Well, it's because you guys have to remember one thing. I was in the Air Force, and our motto was
aim high.
Hey. There you go. But if you don't mind, guys, let's take another quick break. We'll come back for a small segment. We'll get this thing wrapped up. We'll go ahead and head home. You people on the YouTube channel.
YouTube's.
The one fan who's watching, I don't know.
It's probably Jenny.
Is it?
Yeah.
She better be.
I know Destiny's watching. Hi, baby. I love you.
Hi, Jenny. I love you.
Baby, come back.
Everybody wants to give a shout out. Will's just going to say, hey, be right.
Panda.
All right, everybody. We'll be right back in just a minute. You're listening to the Shootout Podcast.
Call me back.
This is going to be a hard thing to do. I'm like, do I really want to do all that?
Man.
Fucking Vossel.
Because he pronounced it like pet tip.
It's her name.
Yeah, he pronounced it like that way.
T-I-T-T.
The emphasis on the tip.
Is she related?
Pet
tit.
It's pet tit.
It's not pet tit. It's pet tit.
P-E-T.
It's pet tit.
T-I-T-T.
Is there an apostrophe in between?
No.
But it's well, yeah, we're saying it's pet tit. He's saying it's pet tit.
Oh, it's pet tit.
That's what she says. She
what
says,
is it?
It's pet tit.
There we go.
Pet tit.
White guy.
I'm going to have fun with her.
Diggity, diggity,
diggity. Other announcement of the soccer team at UTEP. So she's going to be, she'll be on the show. Coach Cross, he's awesome. He loves the show. He watched the Keaton Allen episode.
Oh, you know who loves our show too? The guy that runs a clock for the Reapers.
You know who doesn't love our show? You guys, because you fuckers don't
watch it. I listen to every show.
Listen,
I just missed one show. Damn.
Yeah, sure.
We haven't talked about you too. What show did you miss?
Last week. I haven't listened to it yet.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We gave him some love. A little bit more.
You don't deserve to listen to Dennis talk, man.
Yeah, you don't get to listen to the legend. Okay. You just skip past that.
But our clock keeper, he's like, hey, man, and I didn't even bring it up. He brought it up. He's like, hey, man, I listen to your show all the time, bro. I love that shit. It's awesome.
Was it the guy that we met?
No, it's a different guy. Dude? Oh, yeah, yeah, that dude, okay, the big yeah. dude, Edmundo. Yeah. And he's like, oh, dude, I love your show, man. It's so much better than Sports Talk. That's actually what he said any prompt to. And I was like,
whoa,
I was like, hey, man, thank you, buddy.
Sorry, Steve.
Sorry, Steve, but that's what the dude said.
You did it to yourself.
I guarantee you.
Yeah, I would. But he, but yeah, that's what he said. He's like, I really enjoy listening to your show, man.
Yeah, we had 1,600 and some odd viewers.
That's good number.
For a week, it's not too bad. That's the most we've had.
Really?
Yep. The prior to that, the most we had was 1527. I keep that.
With the Jenny Hunt and Jennifer Hunt show.
So last week went over.
Do you archive the audio along with the video, or does the video just go out?
The audio goes out onto my website, which is tippinsports.com. You could ask these dudes. I pump it literally every single day.
Can I figure out how I can do it for our sports page? I can bring the link over.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you know, a certain somebody here who might be named Michael Tippin applied for a job over there at the Paso Herald Post.
Oh! You did?
got kicked straight in the nards.
I was like, right in the Reggie Bush. Right in the Reggie Bush.
That was awkward. Still, thrillers.
Yeah, actually.
In the middle of that. That's an AAB conversation.
You'd be surprised.
Had it like BFL.
We're as obscure as, you know, Johnny Guillen. It's not. Right. Yeah, he's not.
You know,
well, you want to find out about marriage. Other things, but.
The wrestling league that's coming up?
It's nice, wait a minute, wrestling league?
The wrestling, the New Era Wrestling.
Oh, yeah, New Era Wrestling. I follow them. They're pretty fucking dope.
And what they
it's like wrestling?
Yeah.
Like wrestling?
Lucha.
It looks
really?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're going to have to get that shit in here.
Nerd moment of my life. I love wrestling, all right? Mm-hmm. I'm a big-ass Chris Jericho fan. That's the reason why my son is named. I just turned it off.
Or nothing wrong with that. We should get them on, though.
That's how much.
The results from the UTEP rugby or the Scorpions. That's big time. I mean, the Scorpions go all the way back to 73. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're known.
That's established.
And that was something I was surprised about the other day, because I was talking to somebody who is a friend of mine who works here on UTEP, and she loves rugby. And I forgot, you know, just in my head, because there's so many other things going on. I was like, we need to start covering this rugby because they want it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Hopefully you're not watching. Yeah. And if you are watching,
you won't.
Yeah, you won't.
But here's the thing is that, when I'm sitting there at Channel 9 or I'm sitting at Channel 7 and I get all these releases, it's like rugby and I get golf, and I know that that's not going to make it. And on the post, it all goes up.
That's the best.
And because there's parents and there's athletes and there's, they need to know that stuff's going on.
Kevin usually loves local stuff.
But he loves local stuff.
That'll hit.
When it fits into the marketing of the station. And rugby, and RGFL doesn't.
Don't.
Yeah.
So when you can having to do with who's at the county courthouse, and you'd be surprised when you can tell them what you've done, and then tell them what you've done again, and then show them what you've done. You can't do that with what's it in the golf race. You finished 15th, didn't you? And
that
fucking NCAA. That's awesome. Soccer team, rugby team. There's a reason that we're only playing to 400 people. And that's why I tell the guys, it's like our league, the RGFL, is in the exact position that the old Texas league was, the old AA Texas league. 1 year Tucson would be in it, next year Tucson would be in it. We're starting our own league. And it wasn't until the teams of the 20th century that it finally got standardized and people started to realize it. And the Post back then was the champion of the little sports. Like, there was only one place in boxing that would go to the El Paso High Auditorium and watch a boxing match of these two middleweights that nobody knew except the gyms that they were representing and their families.
Yeah.
they started hyping him up. And it's the same thing with the football team. It's the same thing with the rugby team. And yeah, it's a little bit activist. But if you're not going to, if you're going to be the compromise, you're going to be the stage where you need to come forward. Push your city. Push your city. Get
there. I do it all the time. I always try to sneak in all types of stories. Just try to do that minute and a half, and either Brenda will shoot it down or.
I can tell you right now, I sent the release for the RGFL to Brenda because I know she'll look at it. I sent it to the news desk and I sent it to Luke. That by going to the news desk, Carlos hates me.
Really? Well, Carlos is crazy though. He's only on the weekends and he's.
No, hi,
he's
Carlos.
No, believe me. If Carlos is watching, he's watching the cartel beheading video right now. That's what he's watching.
Yeah, dude, these freaking chihuahuas last week. His three dogs, they shit in the fucking newsroom. He's he didn't clean it up.
He's wild.
Really?
He would go to the point. I even caught him on video. Stuff was disappearing out of BMPS, which is our computer system, which keeps track of the newscast.
So we stack all the stories and everything. Yeah.
I'd have stuff 3 weeks out, and we'd get to it. I was like, I know I put it in there. And you know how we've got the boards, right?
Yeah.
The boards are my idea to keep track of stuff because stuff was disappearing. And I would write stuff down for the morning crew, and I caught him on video erasing stuff I put up there. Because he was afraid I was going to take his job.
He thinks he knows everything. He got a Peabody Award with like five other people in one story.
In FAA. And you know what?
Yeah.
His stories about WFAA? First of all, let me retract. He was a very good photographer. His portfolio is solid.
As a photographer, though.
As a photographer.
Yeah.
His FAA stories, he's always part of the team. And even the guys that work with him at FAA, I talked to directly because I was at news desk, they hated his ass. Because he says, hey, check this out, Chris. And he pushed me the cartel people sawing off live people's heads. First thing in the morning. And I got him. I finally got tired of it one day. And it was right.
Yeah, because I always watch that at the end of the day.
It was. Well, that's the thing. It's appropriate at no time. But
yeah.
I would fight with him because he would want to put this. Oh, we got to put this drug battle in. It's like, what does my grandma care about Denise?
Yes.
Yeah. Right. What was it?
So what the thing was, he was. Oh, check this out. This lady got hit today in Juarez, and she got stuck with a truck's wheel. I was like, dude, you know my aunt just died 2 weeks ago. From a hit and run driver in Fabens, and somebody stole the money that she was going to pay the bills out of her purse, right? And you're showing me a hit and run driver?
Yeah, that's pretty fucked up.
30 seconds, and then he goes, calls an intern over. Hey, check this out.
Yeah, no, he's out there. You're right. He's just kind of a waste of skin.
Well, did you send it to Bo Bagley? He did a story last year on the game.
I got Bo. I got everybody. I've got everybody.
Okay. Because Bo actually did do a story.
Yeah,
Yeah.
So I put my contact information. Everybody saw it. I sent it to Lou. I sent it to Casey. Everybody's got it. So I think we're good. It's just that I bypassed him by sending it to Brenda and everybody else. But here, watch his face. Watch his face. Look at him. Okay, ready?
Hey, Chief, let me tell you something about what happened. These guys got caught at the bridge, and they had an AK-47, and they stuck it up his ass, and they started firing, and the bullets came out his ears. Chief, we got to get that on. I was just talking to my guy over in Juarez,
right?
Yeah,
and I'm ready to turn, man.
The cause now is on the weekends, and the weekend, the weekends, no one gives a shit about.
Yeah,
so
but
it's
still,
just
it's hard. It's hard to overpower Carlos. If he's running the weekends,
he comes in and screams and yells, and you need to be doing this, and screaming and yelling at Luke, and I'm just like, I don't give a shit.
Hey, Chief, why don't we have the people flying a chihuahua in a helium balloon? That's breaking news.
Like I told you about these little chihuahuas, those three little yipers, and they shit all over the place.
Oh, yeah.
Pissed all over the place. He didn't clean it up. I was like, damn.
I've done that
before. Yeah.
I did that right now in the classroom over there.
I couldn't make it to the bathroom.
I'm just pissed on the sink, man.
One more segment, guys.
All right.
One more.
Uno más.
Uno más.
Uno más.
What the hell?
That sounds like a door at my parents' house.
God bless you.
No, no shit. I don't know if you guys believe in ghosts or not. My parents' house haunted.
The Kukui?
I'm watching. We
will.
Okay. Would you like to play a game?
I thought I buried those hookers.
Oh, shit. Hey, Chief, I got a story for you.
Well, Aaron buried a couple of hookers.
They never stay buried. That's the problem.
They never stay buried.
Zombie hookers from the toy box.
Right. A friend will help you bury your body. A best friend will help you bury a live body.
Toy box.
I have a friend who's a.
I don't think we're going to be on that page that he's talking about.
Right. I think we should
move that right in the
once I get everything edited. Don't you lowball me.
We'll clean it tomorrow.
We're shooting ourselves in the dick, gentlemen. We're shooting ourselves in the dick.
Some people like that.
All right. We got bras in Atlanta.
Muscle. Favorite Harry movie.
Awesome.
Panda.
You see what we got to deal with?
See, there's a difference between on-air talent and off-air talent, and we like to expose that every show.
Maybe
I'm going to
make you blow you
off
air.
Hey! Whoa!
Never argue with the person who's got the pan. Turn that mic off.
And our rating just went to an end.
He's our Fernie.
Hey, whoa.
We'll start calling you Vassal Cuevas.
Oh, Fernie, I love you, by the way.
Fernando.
He's one of my favorite Twitter feeds, Fernie. That's awesome.
All right, man.
All right, let's do this final segment. Those of you who are watching, like I said, I don't have the numbers in front of me. I phoned Dad a little while ago. But if you're watching, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jenny.
In the words of Kevin Durant, Jenny, Destiny, you're
the real MVP.
There it is.
Yeah, this champagne of beers for you.
One more toast.
I don't have any. I just finished mine.
Oh.
We'll get you another one. What the hell? Whoa.
Oh, I know. Who toasts with an empty
who
bottle?
Who toasts with an empty bottle?
Yeah. Luckily, we get to do a replay here.
Yeah.
For five.
Yeah, there we go. See, here it is.
I've been shot for less.
Here's what really happened. There we go.
I got robbed in Atlanta.
Let's see, with the champagne of beers, I have celebrated NASCAR style by hiring at Channel 7. By hiring at Channel 9 and my starting with the Herald Post.
I love the way it's a NASCAR style.
It is, it's NASCAR style.
Shotgun NASCAR.
Right here, shook it up, climbed out of the window of my Buick Roadmaster wagon, and she handed me the beer, and that thing, just like Victory Lane.
Nice.
Each time. Awesome.
You know how much beer this man had to come?
$250 fine for littering.
It was in Fabens. Okay. They don't count those.
It doesn't matter, Fabens. It's cool.
I have a Buick Century. It's a 1973 Buick Century. I also have a 1997 Buick Roadmaster.
Nice.
There you go.
See, my Roadmaster is a 5.7 wagon with a Woody side.
See, I had a 1991 Ford.
I just have a Woody.
Listen to this.
My bad.
We're trying to impress Babcock over here.
That went out the window fucking an hour ago.
Well, with a name like Babcock, you know it's just.
We're trying to impress Babcock.
Shout out to Babcock's wife.
Let me shake this one up then and spray that one all over the place.
Wouldn't be the first time.
This dude said, "I'm trying to impress Babcock's wife," and he's talking about a 2-year-old in front of a fucking toy box.
What?
It's like, yeah, I'm trying to impress people with, you know, Babcock and stuff, but I was scared of this 2-year-old.
It was creepy as hell, man!
And whenever he turned his head around, it was 360.
Yeah! You see a little kid, like, you open up your eyes and he's staring at you, he's like, oh, Jesus Lord. And little kids are creepy. You don't know this? You know little kids?
True that. Yeah.
You know, I have probably some of the weirdest fears. Like, I don't like clowns. I'm afraid of heights.
Yeah. Clowns
are weird.
Or bears. Terrified of bears.
I got kicked out of the KLAQ Haunted Warehouse once because I punched a clown. I told him, I was walking through, I said, if there's a clown, do not come out. He came out.
Tink.
But I may or may not have gone to jail that night. But
he'll only do that once.
Well, actually, then they spring back up. You can do it a couple times. Boing.
That's what he thought.
That's what she said. But, yeah, so let's jump into this final segment. I forgot what the fuck I was going on with this. But we'll jump into this final segment. Those of you who are watching on the live YouTube feed, thank you once again for watching.
Panda.
I am the Gunslinger Michael Tippin. We have the legendary Chris Babcock with us. Apparently the man who's watched every championship the Cowboys have ever won. And the Celtics.
And the Celtics.
The second oldest person on the shootout. We have Will Herron, who's the third oldest person. And the oldest person, Michael Montez, is here with us as well.
Panda.
I'm the oldest?
We also had the not so legendary halfway transvestite Vossel Zabinol with us. How'd that surgery go, by the way?
Honestly, I'm kind of offended. I'm halfway. I'm not even either or. Like,
whoa. Halfway. Well, you only cut off half your penis, Lorena Bobbitt style.
Well, Will only wanted half of it.
I did. So I can wear it around my neck.
He's like, fold that son of a bitch in half.
He got braids in Atlanta. Braids in Atlanta.
But we went a little out there. We were supposed to talk about the Cavs the last segment. You know, the NBA Finals. We talked about
the game three, by the way.
Did they win game three?
Damn it. There was my sweep.
So it's a 2-1 series lead. I still think it's going to be in five. I know last week I said the Cavs were going to win it in six. From what I saw, I don't think that the Cavs still have what it takes. Because like Chris said earlier, game three, you came back home. You lost the last two just big. You got to have something to fight for. Golden State's going to get it together. They're going to wax in these next two games. It's going to be Golden State in five.
I don't know. I think the Cavs are better without Kevin Love. I think the concussion actually helps Cavs. I think starting – I don't know who they started in this place because we were here, but they won by 30 tonight. I mean, they did shoot really well. They shot almost 50%, if not 50%.
Dropping dimes.
But, I mean, they beat them by 30 at home.
I'm just pissed because I don't get a free taco tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. No.
The road team takes a game on the road. Get a free taco. Tacos, Jackie. Tacos for everybody.
But that brings me to my next topic, and thank you. Yesterday, the El Paso Chihuahuas lost to the Fresno Tacos. However, the Chihuahuas are still in first place. They have a 4-game lead over Las Vegas.
They're killing it.
Yep.
They literally started this season off as bad as a team possibly could have. Mm-hmm. They had rainouts. It was like, you know, there was some sort of conspiracy theory against the El Paso Chihuahuas. Everything went wrong for them. They've put it together right now. They're in first place. They're representing El Paso nice and good. Do you think these guys can get everything together, get back on a win streak here? They only lost one game. But get back on a win streak here and ultimately win the PCL title. I know we're...
I think that it depends a lot on where San Diego, where the Padres end up in the NL. I think if the Padres stay middle of the pack and they don't start making a move toward the pennant, I think we can stay, the Chihuahuas will stay intact in that core, the Slash Brothers, everybody else. The pitching needs a little bit more work. They're giving up a lot of these goofy little one or two runs. I think, again, it's the parent club, it's AAA. It really depends on the parent club. But, you know, they're looking pretty good right now coming up on the All-Star break in, what, 3 weeks or so? They're in better shape than they were last year. I can tell you that much. They look a lot better.
And they won their division.
Yeah.
They're 35-23 right now. They're 8-2 in their last 10. And they're coming home. Yeah.
Against Sacramento.
4-game set against who is that? Sacramento.
It's the Sacramento River Cats.
The River Cats.
Shout out to 600 ESPN El Paso, where I get sports on the River Cats.
We love 600 ESPN El Paso. I don't know. We've said that enough tonight.
I don't know if you guys have noticed this with the Grizzly games this past week, like weekend and such. If you watch any of the news stations, they don't have any highlights of those games because apparently the Grizzlies don't cut the highlights and drop them to that PCL file.
Right.
What we were doing initially is we would record the games off the internet.
MILB.
Yeah, MILB, exactly.
Amazing.
They're fantastic. And then we come back and we cut it, but the quality of the video is terrible. So Kevin was like, no, we're not going to do that anymore. So here on out, the PCL, the actual people that run the league, they had told the other teams to cut the highlights after the game or during the game so that all the different television stations can have something to cut and then broadcast. Well, they don't.
No, they don't.
They don't, and it's ridiculous.
Before we continue with that, just to let you guys know how much of a Yankees homer I am. I watched the Scranton-Wilkes-Barre Yankees before every Chihuahuas game.
That's cool.
We used to watch, we would watch the Paw Sox and then the Chihuahuas play.
Pawtucket?
Yep.
You know, Pawtucket is such a terrible place. I mean, just the name Red Sox is such a terrible nickname. It's a garbage team.
Going back to your question, if they can win the PCL, they have the second best record right now. Nashville has the best record at 36-22.
And Nashville is actually, they've won 24 out of their last 30 games.
Who's the Nashville team?
Sound.
Nashville Sound.
The Chihuahuas are second. Then Tacoma has the third best record at 34-24. But a lot of it, like Chris said, it depends on what the Padres are doing, how far back they are in the NL West.
Well, you have to look at the parent teams, right? So what happened actually yesterday, as a matter of fact, for the Cubs, they lost Jorge Soler, and they brought up probably their best prospect from AAA. There's time for El Paso to lose somebody because of the Padres can lose someone like Matt Kemp because, as we know, he's very injury prone. Yeah. As Dodger fans, you guys know that.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my.
And they could lose somebody like an Alex Dickerson or like a Hunter Renfro, who's leading the league in not only batting average, but runs scored and, all these other things that you always have. And I'll bring this over to you, Chris, because I need to just drill this into Will Heron's head. Does the atmosphere here in El Paso...
We're going to do this again?
The elevation of
El Paso. All right.
It's like the month-long conversation.
What do you think?
I don't think it does. Haven't seen a
lot.
Damn it!
I haven't seen a lot of the Outlaws games. And they actually, they take that next step. They have the humidor. They keep the balls in there. Actually, I don't care where you keep your balls. If you got a guy that can...
Chris!
If you got somebody that can hit it...
You want to see him?
They're gone.
Whoa.
I was the only one.
I'll say this. He's been on time, that's why. But I'll bring up the same thing to you that I brought to Will last week. The El Paso Diablos averaged for a 30-year span 122 home runs. Okay. The El Paso Chihuahuas, even though they've hit so many, so many balls out of the park, they've only hit at a maximum 115. So I think the elevation does have something to do, because if you look at Cohen Stadium, we've all been out to Cohen Stadium.
Yeah.
That wall is gigantic, and it's full of thousand sponsors.
These little stars didn't do very well.
What?
Sorry. The person in my class was talking about this. Music Under the Stars is done out at Cohen Stadium now, right?
They're switching it out for...
Yeah.
They're doing half of the first part at Cohen, and then they're going back to the Chumas.
Okay, I'll say this.
There you go.
Nobody wants to drive out to the Northeast.
I couldn't agree. I hate to... I lived on the Northeast. Mm-hmm. Probably in the
Northeast. I have a lot of friends in the Northeast.
I was born
Nobody.
On the Northeast. El Diablo Clinic on Macombs.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That's good.
All about the Northeast.
No wonder, you're all tatted up. But nobody wants to go to the Northeast.
But you know what? Music Under the Stars hasn't been the same since they took away the ability to take alcohol.
Yeah.
Because I used to go all the time.
I just got a thing.
Like 3 or 4 years ago now.
Oh, okay.
And you could go and you could take a cooler and sit there and just, it was the best thing ever. And when they changed that, and when they wanted to start making money off of it with all the food trucks and the beer trucks and all that stuff, totally changed.
One of the first.
It didn't surprise me at all that it sucked last week.
One of the first dates that I had with Destiny, because we've been together for a while.
Oh.
One of the first dates that we had, we went out to Music Under the Stars, and I got so... And the fact that she was able to put up with that and was like, you know, that's decent.
Keep her.
You're an okay guy. I was like, oh, I love you so much.
Yeah, after that, she goes, you know, those were duels, right?
And I was like, no, it was bottles of water.
Pee everywhere.
I'm so duels. Drunk right now. I do know somebody who got high off of hookah, though. I'll go back to that some other day.
Going back to the Diablos, as far as the Northeast was concerned, when they played at Dudley, that was an odd field to be a hitter's field, and it was. I mean, but again, we're trying to compare double A and then unaffiliated ball with triple A. So you've got a huge jump up, because from triple A to double A, there's just no way you're going to catch up to it. But from unaffiliated to triple A is it's like another galaxy.
We said it was like glorified high school baseball, if that.
Yeah, it was basically semi
terrible.
We all could have gone out there and struck out some people.
Right, exactly. I mean, at one point,
I would have beamed some people on purpose.
I have a camera, by the way.
He does.
I could go 3 innings at one time. My fastball was around 89 miles an hour.
Damn.
I could go for 3 innings solid.
I can throw hard, not straight. That's my problem.
I've got control, but now, arm is floppy. I maybe go an inning. But when they were unaffiliated, I could have gone. I would have probably been middle.
Shit! Nice.
Chris Babcock, every day.
So then you've got a shorter porch with this Chihuahua field, almost like Fenway Park. More with the dimensions that they have at Petco. So you're going to have that ability to hit, but the problem is. In your situations.
So I'm trying to take my job, Babcock.
No, I'm Jamaican. I got 6 jobs, so I need this other one. By the way, I'm the new GM of the water polo team. The El Paso Mariachis.
Right. You do bobsledding?
The one thing I like about this team, and going back to the Diablos, and one of the people when I do PA, I kind of, he was my idol at that time. But going back to his made-up stats that became true with the Diablos, he used to have this thing where it was, there's nobody in Major League Baseball that scores more runs with two outs in the eighth inning than the offense. Everybody would go, that. But if you look at the way the Chihuahuas have gone since last September to now with their comeback
games. One of the best teams.
It's true. Yeah. You cannot, even with a huge lead, you cannot count them out. And that is talent. And when you can have that confidence, you know, having coached, if you're going to win, I would prefer to just blow them out in the first quarter, the first inning, get that stuff. Don't wait till the last minute because, it's exciting. But if you've got the talent to do it up front, don't wait till the last inning, the last quarter to do it. But the Chihuahuas do it consistently. Oh. And to do it consistently takes a lot of talent.
Tim said, I think it was last night or 2 days ago before the game.
Whatever, I was working the game.
I think so. Yeah, the late night.
Name dropper.
I dropped the job.
They lead all of baseball with hits. Mm-hmm. They have like over 600 hits. They average like 9 hits a game.
Not only do they lead all of professional baseball in hits, they also have the highest batting average in all of professional baseball.
That's incredible. Right here in El Paso.
Is that Rod Brajas or is that the El Paso Stadium?
That's the stadium. To me, I think it's the stadium because they have so many long balls.
But I think it's talent that they have. Nickerson and Renfro. But I think it's a lot of that. I think it's.
But let's say
it's a combination.
Let's say they have a flip. Okay, they bring Matt Kemp down here to AAA. I
mean, does that help them or hurt them?
They take someone like Renfro out. Mm-hmm. I think that helps them because I think we've seen it over the last few years. James Loney was not really a power hitter, but here in the park, he looked like just some sort of freak of nature.
See, my whole thing though is if you bring a guy like Kemp down here, what kind of attitude is he going to bring down here? Well, he is now. But if you bring him down here, how is he going to be in the clubhouse? That's my thing. Is he going to break it up, or is he going to be like, hey, this is cool. I'm in AAA baseball.
I was going to say something pretty messed up, but I'll be nice and reserved right now, so we'll be all right.
I think the way that Barajas has the lineup, and again, having his experience being in the bigs, being with the Diamondbacks, being with the Diablos, when you get to a certain point with the lineup, you have to start looking at run production. And he has that down. I mean, you can have a lineup, and I've done this tons of times in Little League, and it's weird because Little League is with baseball, you can compare Little League is back.
Their everyday lineup that are batting over 350.
Yep.
Alex Dickerson right now is batting 410. 410 this late into the season.
29 game hit streak.
Carlos Asuaje is batting 396. So you have those two guys right there. They're in the middle of the line. That's the heart of your lineup right there. And they produce so many runs. And it goes like what Chris said. I mean, Barajas to me is an amazing. People talk about the just such a great baseball, basketball. Just watching the way he's
Baumgartner.
They're both betting 190s.
Baumgartner.
Kershaw.
But again, you've got a 390 hitter in front of him, and then behind him, you've got at least a 290. So you're going to cover him. He might get that bloop single, and that puts another guy on first base that. The two and three hitter can advance to third.
And then check out this stat for the Chihuahuas, okay, just to show you how amazing they're playing during this little stretch and for the beginning of the season. Their team batting average is .316. The second place team in the PCL is Las Vegas, once again another high elevated place. And they're batting .280.
Mets.
The Mets are garbage. They are.
Yeah, they are.
Well, not this year. I mean, they're not as good as the Yankees have always.
No, the Mets suck. This is basically the Mets suck.
That's how far has the Dark Knight fallen? Like, maybe it's like Light Knight. Is that what it's been called? That like Matt Harvey's. I don't know. That dude. He's not Strasburg.
I was just saying the Cubs are killing it. What in the world?
Like I said,
is this gonna last or?
I hope it lasts. I swear Arrieta? To God, I hope this lasts until Game 7 of the World Series and they lose.
He hates the Cubs. Hates the Cubs.
I want to see the Cubs and their jerk off fans get that heart just ripped right out of them
again.
Game 7, walk off in lights.
And what are you gonna do if they win?
What am I gonna do if they win?
Hey, Cubs win! Cubs win! The Cubs!
Jerry, Jerry.
Hey, let me ask you, I hate the Cubs.
I just think the Cubs are a terrible team.
They get, you know, seriously, again, from the first time we got cable in here, you're watching the Cubs and you're like, hey, that's a good team. What? How the hell did they lose that game? And that's where we watched, again, outside of Saturday baseball, without cable, when we got cable, we got Cubs games. And it was like, oh, this is good.
WGN or something like that.
Yeah.
With Skip Carey.
me being the way I am, okay? I wanted the Cubs to win the World Series. I wanted the Red Sox to win that first World Series, okay? Because I don't like seeing these teams lose consistently.
Yeah.
I like to see teams win. I mean, I might be a front runner. I love to see teams win. Whenever the Cubs lost that 0-3 World Series against the Miami Florida Marlins, whenever they lost it against the Florida Marlins, and they blame Steve Bartman for it, even though there
Which
was
is ridiculous.
And a bunch of innings left.
The dumbest thing I've ever heard.
That wasn't a World Series. That was a Champions.
Whenever they lost that NLCS to Florida, and they blamed
Bartman. It wasn't even Bartman that grabbed the ball. It was the dude next to him.
It was a whole bunch of people.
Yeah.
Everybody else.
Moises picked up front.
Moises Alou jumps up, and he's nowhere near that ball.
Yeah.
And the shortstop made an error like on the next play that could have been at the inning or something like that.
And he had to leave the town.
Yeah, and it was like nobody blames that guy.
Yep.
Bartman,
the little obscure dude in the stands, gets all the blame.
That's a Walkman.
Nobody blames Dusty Baker for using his pitchers for like 454 innings.
You remember he left his kid as like the bat boy or something like that?
Yeah,
the kid
ran over
and the player to run over like scoop him up and save his life. Get your kid.
I know way too much about nothing.
Barry Bonds and the other guy got in a fight. I remember that.
Barry Bonds and Jeff Kent.
Yeah, yeah, they got mad at each other. I remember that.
It's because they were both juicing, so they had that roid right
there. Exactly. And that McGuire effect.
100% true.
McGuire Canseco.
Did Barry Bonds need the juice? Let's be honest. He would have been a Hall of Famer without it.
Yeah, he would have. There would have been no question about it, but he just wanted that next level.
Yeah, he wouldn't have broken the home run right
there. The only player with 500 home runs and 500 steals.
Yeah.
And how awesome was Barry Bonds as a player? And then he's this big drag down too.
I was a big Pirates fan when he was. Well, I was a Pirates fan. I was his fan while he was a Pirate.
I saw him in LA once. The Killer Bees with Bonilla.
Yeah.
I saw them in LA one time for a 4th of July game.
That's awesome.
When I was little.
Bobby Bonilla. The best contract in the history of the
He's still getting paid.
Still getting paid.
He's still getting paid by the Mets.
All the way through 2025.
Yeah.
That's got to be the smartest man in the history of
sports.
He's
as smart as the guys who sold the St. Louis Spirits.
There you go.
Right.
Yep.
And they're still making money.
They still get
Do you even know who the Spirits of St. Louis are?
I want their agents.
Do you know who they are, though?
Hell no, man. I don't
They were an ABA team that folded, or they were going to actually get into the NBA, but they didn't, like, for some reason, they kind of blackballed them out. But they signed a deal, and they still get TV rights for that deal. From the NBA. They still make money from the
1977.
Yep. Hey, man.
Yep.
Every freaking year.
Do the good agent. We'll do good things for you.
We need people like that.
Yeah, we need that agent.
Yes. Drew Rosenhaus.
Nice.
T.O. still getting paid.
Yeah, he needs to. He has like 8 kids, 6 kids. Bunch of baby's mamas. He was on Oprah crying. Damn.
Yeah.
Well, that's what T.O. does.
Yeah. 2. My quarterback.
Yep.
But, you know, as far as Sports Center El Paso goes, I think there's nothing better than what we got with the Chihuahuas right now. They're on a hot streak. I think personally that they can win the PCL championship.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
But the team that does scare me, like I said earlier, is the Memphis Sound or the Nashville Sound, because they've won 24 out of their last 30 games. I mean,
yeah,
that's
they're on a roll.
Astronomical.
That's ridiculous.
It's when you're hot.
They won yesterday. They were down in the second inning, like 5-0. They won 13-5.
Whoa.
Yeah, they had 6 runs in like 2 different innings. It was amazing to just sit there and watch. But I don't know, guys. What do you guys think about the Chihuahuas? I mean, we've had some good fans out here. We've had some great support. Actually, I don't want to go on the Chihuahuas. I want to talk to you about the soccer stadium that we might be getting.
Nope, not going to happen. If it goes to the public vote, there's too many haters that still hold a grudge against the the Joao Stadium. It's not going to happen.
Do you think it should be allowed to go to a public vote?
I think it needs to. I think it needs to. If you're gonna ask for taxpayer money, it definitely needs to go to a vote.
You weren't here last week. Will, Dennis, and I kind of concluded that even though we'd like to have a stadium here in El Paso, I don't necessarily see how feasible it would be to build a stadium downtown. Dennis is in the mindset that, you know, it's already bought and paid for. I'm in the mindset of, you know, we already have this arena that we're going to build. It's supposed to sit about, what, 20,000 or so. Why not just, house them in there? Do we really need to build another stadium? Why not just house them in there?
Well, the football field wouldn't fit in there, though. Right? If arena would be like the size for a basketball court.
Yeah, it's not going to fit. It's going to be a basketball stadium. The only place it can go is probably going to end up being there at the railroad yards, and they're still not pulled out yet. So, you know how it goes.
Yeah. We definitely got that. We'll go ahead and end the show right now, folks. Once again, I'd like to thank you for tuning in to the Tune Out Podcast. Once again, I'd like to thank you. Those of you watching, do not put this on. Once again, for watching, everybody. I'd like to thank you for tuning in to the Shootout Podcast. For Chris Babcock, for the Gifted Growler, Will Heron, for Michael Montez,
16,
and Vossel Zabinol. I am the Gunslinger, Michael Tippin. We'll see you all next time.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, thank you, thank you.